All right, back here at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium, Mike Kalinowski, the governor, Bob Dunkel with you. It is the Black and Blue Brawl 2016, the rebirth of a rivalry between these Lions and these Clarion area Bobcats. The winner will take home the traveling trophy. And we are in the Carly Tire pregame show here on the KSAC Game of the Week. It is time to take a look at the governor's keys to the game. As Bob takes a look at those keys, it's brought to you by Scales, Kitchen, and Leaper. And Bob, as you look at who, what these teams need to do to come out with a win tonight, what do you look at on each side?
Well, Mike, for Clarion-Limestone, we'll take a look at them first. They are the visitors in the ballgame tonight. They've got to establish the run. Once that running game is established, get that passing game working. They've also got to score early, often, and don't let up. You've also got to keep those emotions in check. Don't let the hype and the rivalry get the best of you. Sometimes that can happen. We all know how emotional high school athletes can be at times, and they've got to eliminate the turnovers. I think that is a huge factor in a ball game. For Clarion, they got to dominate both lines of scrimmage and run the ball effectively. Secondary also must be on their A game. They can't let receivers get past them. That was a big problem with Red Bank Valley last week. There were at times two and three different open receivers past the secondary. Special teams, they're huge. Everything from extra points to the conversion, the two-point conversion attempts, to punt returns, to coverages. You absolutely have to have a strong night on special teams tonight. And, of course, capitalize on those turnovers if you're able to force some. Certainly you want to do that to make it a very difficult night for your opponent.
All right, Bob, that's taking a look at the governor's keys to the game. And again, brought to you by Kale's Kitchen and Leaper. Time to take a look at the kickoff weather report. It's brought to you by Coral Bend Auto Parts and Clarion and Reimersburg. And our kickoff report, it's 75, humid here at the stadium, partly cloudy, mostly cloudy. Actually, right now we do expect a low tonight of about 56 degrees later. And the clouds will hang in there with us throughout the evening. So really, no precipitation expected as we go throughout the game tonight. Perfect field conditions as always here on the turf at Clarion University. The team captains are down there. And Bob's going to take a look at what's going around the KSAC tonight on that schedule. It's brought to you by S&W Auto Body in Lucinda.
Well, taking a look at the large school division, it is Carn City at Punxsutawney. And in non-conference action, obviously that would be large versus small school. Brookville at Red Bank Valley. Union AC Valley at St. Mary's. Montauk at Keystone. So an interesting night here in the KSAC. As the ceremonial coin toss has just taken place. Bobcats did win that toss. They have deferred. Lions will receive to start this one out. Of course, you know, I'm one of those guys. I do the same thing Clarion area did. If you win that toss, save it for the second half.
All right, that's a look at what's going around the conference this evening. Again, brought to you by S&W Auto Body here on the Carly Tire pregame show. That'll do it for the Carly Tire pregame show. And we do want to thank them, as always, for their sponsorship of that. I know we'll be checking it out here shortly as we're getting into fall now. We've got to start thinking about those winter tires again. So get on down to Carly Tire. Lions will get the football to start the game this evening.
You know, Mike, you talked a little bit about that Black and Blue Brawl trophy down there, and that is thanks to All-American Awards and Engraving. And it garnered an awful lot of attention, let me tell you that, here in the pregame festivities. A lot of people eyeing that. I think they had to put it on its own table, Mike. They were afraid that perhaps you might pay someone to steal that
thing. Well, it looks gold. I may take it. You never know. I'm one of those types of people.
Well, you are a thrifty kind of guy.
Yeah. No, you got to be. Is that McAfee back deep? Have to get the glasses on him.
That actually, Mike, is Aiden Wiles back deep.
So Wiles would be the deep man. And getting set to kick the football off here for the Cats. That is Archer Mills.
Now McAfee did return to the deep position. Aiden Wiles will be the up man in front.
All right, so McAfee, the deep man, Archer Mills is ready. Here's the kickoff. He'll send it. It's short. It's going to bounce and be taken by Wiles here on the left side, and he will tiptoe, be hit, knocked out of bounds up around the 38-yard line. The Lions will have good field position as they will take over here first and 10.
A good field position to get this one underway. Great to have you with us tonight. I talked at the top of the pregame. I said, there's absolutely zero wind. I'm watching the flags on both sides. They haven't even moved a 16th of an inch, so absolutely no wind whatsoever tonight on the field. Just a bit humid.
Here come the Lions, Callan, and it will be Hummel. Wide outs to the right. Actually, they're going to go trips right. Single back is McAfee. McCray is the quarterback here for the Lions. They got a big win last week over the Bulldogs. The Bobcats with a win over Keystone. Lions come set, trips to the right, single back is McAfee, and now the whistles blow. Are they ready? They're going to say actually he went out of bounds at the 31-yard line, so that's where the Lions will begin this drive. Again, the first quarter is brought to you by Red Bank Chevrolet. The handoff, McAfee over the right side, busts through the line, and he'll get up near the 35-yard line. Good run by McAfee, picks up 4 yards. Good crowd on hand here at Memorial tonight. Excellent turnout by both of these schools.
It is still some seats available, certainly if you want to come out and support either team, or if you just want to see some good football, I think you're going to see that as well. Lions quickly in and out of the huddle, ready to take care of business.
Cal in the wide out to the right. It is Ledbetter wide out to the left in the I formation are the backs. They're going to give the ball. McAfee, keeping the football, and they are going to dump that pass off to Hummel. It's a first down across the 43 up to the 44 near the 45-yard line. And for Hummel, that will be a pickup of about 10 on the play for him and a first down here for the Lions as they take it out to the 45-yard line.
A nice high percentage safe play. I think the Bobcats were looking run all the way. We talk all the time, the passing game, you don't have to throw these 30 and 40-yard bombs. Don't get me wrong, they're great, but set up the high percentage, short-distance passes, get the offense in a rhythm early on.
Lions up to the line of scrimmage, man in motion from the right to the left side of the line. That's Hummel. McAfee the lone back. Receiver goes in motion from the left side. They're going to hand that football off and getting hit in the backfield and drop. That's McAfee. He's not going to go anywhere. Actually, that's Wiles getting the carry. Wiles will be the one knocked down for the loss on the play of three. Back near the 42-yard line. So second down here in 13.
Yeah, great penetration that time by Josh Bannock. So he's able to get into the backfield. You want to also have yourself, Mike, in second makeable, third makeable. Now you've just lost 3 yards in that place. You're a little bit in a hole right now.
Second down, close to 13. The ball snapped back to McCray. Rolls to the right side, dumps off the screen to the right to McAfee. Here's McAfee. He's got across the 45-40. Still down in Clarion territory. Lowers the shoulders all the way down to the 34-yard line. Oh, what a run after the catch by McAfee.
Very well executed that time. 23-yard gain there for McAfee, but extremely well executed because the big key there was McCray held onto the ball. The linebackers couldn't react because they didn't know whether he was going to run, whether he was going to dish it off. Very well executed play. Anytime you can freeze the backers, you've got to figure that's good for at least an additional 5 yards over whatever you would have normally picked up anyways.
McCray under center. He's going to hand the football off. McAfee again over the right side, lowers the shoulder, gets through that line of scrimmage, and he'll go forward for a couple as he gets down near the 32. We'll see where they've put the football. That'll be a gain of two, second down at 8. The Lions in Bobcat territory here in this black and blue brawl this evening.
Great to have you with us. 9:40 on the clock. This ball game just underway. The Lions are moving right to left on your computer screen.
Ball at the 32-yard line. Here's McCray under center. Single receiver off to the right. They'll send a man in motion on that sweep. From the right to the left, that's Wiles. Wiles 30, 25, spinning around to the 20, and he's down near that M&B Ready Mix red zone as he's right near the 20-yard line, and another first down here for the Lions.
Well executed that time. The offensive line doing an outstanding job of sealing the blocks, and you know it's a great job blocking. They've got the arms extended there, Michael. And that way there's no chance they're going to hold. They're not going to commit any infractions. The official right on top of it.
Gain of 12. Nose of the football resting on the 20. That'll put it in the M&B Ready Mix red zone. Backs in the I formation. They'll split a single receiver each side. Tight end goes in motion from the right to the left side of the line. McAfee dotting the I. McCray fakes, rolls to the right side. He's looking. McCray pumps once. Now he slips in. He will fall. He'll lose about a yard on the play back near the 22-yard line. See where they put him. Officially, looks like about a loss of two. Make it a loss of three back to the 23, so a second down here in 13.
Yeah, that time McCray a little undecided on the throw. He had an opportunity to run, but by the time he wanted to, I think, initially stop and throw, and then he realized he was no man's land, actually just lost the footing out there.
Lions come up to the line of scrimmage. It's second down here in 13. The ball resting at the Clarion 23-yard line. Opening drive here of the football game. Here's the pitch back to McAfee. McAfee looks a room over the left side. He gets through one tackler and down near the 15-yard line. And for McAfee, that's a gain of 8. And will set up a third down now in 5.
McAfee chugging along. Looked like that play was going to be stopped at the line of scrimmage. Initial contact made. And he just kept the legs churning and gets the team down a makeable third and five situation. Obvious four down territory unless something catastrophic happens here on down number three. But one of the things you think about is rather than throwing, getting greedy, get half the yardage or so here in a run.
Ledbetter, the wide out to the right. The backs that get in the I formation. McCray under center. They're going to go right back to McAfee over the right side. He's got a first down to the 10 and a first and goal for the Lions as he takes it down to the 9-yard line. A 6-yard pickup for McAfee.
And great job by McAfee. Mike, I don't know, you maybe aren't paying as close attention to this part of the game as what I am, but I love the quick snap counts. You know, there's just a matter of everybody barely gets set at the line to snap the ball. What that does, it makes it difficult for the defense to get adjusted. You're literally kind of catching them on their heels because they're trying to get a line based on your formation.
Lions up to the line of scrimmage. It is a first and goal from the 9-yard line. In motion goes Hummel left to right, back to McCray. McCray fires the football down toward the goal line. Is it caught? It is. Yes, it is caught. And that is Hummel down there. There is a flag on the play, though, on the far side.
Not sure that was thrown very early on in the play on that far side of the football field.
Could be in the area of holding, too. They're going to say motion against the offense, so that'll back them up.
That'll negate the reception.
Yeah, puts it back to, going to move it over to this side on the hash mark, I believe back near the 14-yard line after the 5-yard penalty. Yes. So it's still a first and goal from the 14, Governor.
Well, you know, the optimist says now that just gives the offense more room to work. Let's see if that's true. Wide side of the field now is to that right. McCray enjoys rolling out to his right, although certainly we know that he can roll to the left and make the same throws. He's in shotgun formation this down.
He's going to send McAfee in motion to the right side. Dumps the pass off. Wide open in the end zone. Caught in an easy touchdown to Hummel in the end zone. 14 yards, and the Lions are on the board first.
Oh, my. I think that caught everybody in that defense. They were surprised. They got outstanding penetration because what it wasn't a true screen, but the linemen basically stood up as if they were setting up for a screen, and the linebackers and defensive line had all kinds of great penetration, and by the time they realized what was going on, it was too late.
And we'll see what they decide to do, whether they'll go for two or the single-point conversion. They're going to go for two. Well, the Lions, they'll split single receivers on each side. McCray will work out of the shotgun. They'll send a man in motion right to left. He'll work to the right side. Pitches it out to McAfee. McAfee has room. He's into the end zone for the two-point conversion. And it is 8-0 Lions. 6:48 to go here in quarter number one. The Lions lead at 8-0. We'll take a timeout. Back with more after this. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse. And it's right here on exploreclarion.com.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community's need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins Road in Clarion. Call us toll-free at 1-800-262-2118.
Attention all car buyers. The biggest year-end clear-the-lot blowout is happening this month at Clarion Ford. All 2016s must go, and Clarion Ford will give you your best deal, along with 0% up to 72 months financing during the Ford Freedom Sales event. And find fantastic year-end prices on all 2016 Ford F-150s, America's best-selling truck for 39 years. And get 0% for 72 months or over $5,000 in factory rebates and bonus cash. Remember, nobody beats a Clarion Ford deal. Nobody. Clarion Ford, East Main Street.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving. you know the average in-state public college is $20,800 per year and a private school averages over $45,000? Are you prepared to help your child or grandchild go to college? There are many savings options and tax incentives for you to consider. We can help you create a college savings plan. Visit JannieClarion.com to learn more or call us at 223-9990. Jannie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist: savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
All right, back here at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium, the Lions on the board first as they lead Clarion area now by the score of 8-0. Touchdown pass to Hummel.
13-play drive, Mike. That's a great way. I don't think Coach Eggleton could have done a better job scripting that one out in his dreams.
Here's the kickoff, taken at the 20, up to the 25, and knocked down at about the 29-yard line with the return. That was Sterling Connor.
And for the Bobcats, you know, they've been down this road before, Mike. I remember a Carn City game we came a couple years ago. Carn City drove the length of the field, scored. Clarion responded, and then they responded again and again and again, and they pulled away from Carn City in that ball game.
The quarterback is Spencer Miller as he works his way onto the football field as the Bobcats find themselves down 8-0 here in the Black and Blue Brawl. A nice shiny trophy down there goes to the winning side for the next year. Rapp and McCloskey will, actually McCloskey will be in the backfield. And the split Rapp out to that left side. Wonder if they'll sweep with him. They are going to bring him around. And the pitch back to him over the right side. Here's Rapp, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. And out of bounds up near midfield goes Rapp. And that'll be a pickup of nearly 21 on the play as they'll put him down. Make it 20 as they'll put him out at the 49-yard line. And a big run by Rapp.
Mike, you called that one all the way. You and I both were on the same page there. You could see that sweep. It was coming. And that guy, when he gets into the open field, look out. Because you better be in the secondary because that's your only chance to make a tackle because you're not going to run him down from behind.
And again, they'll come with the same setup as Miller will come under center. McCloskey in the backfield. They'll have Rapp on the right side this time. They're going to sweep Rapp from right to left, and he's going to try to turn the corner, and he's going to be hit and drop. Shorter gain this time. He'll get it across midfield and down to the CL 48-yard line. But is there a – no, no flag. Thought there might have been. So a three-yard pickup sets up a second down here in 7 for the Bobcats.
Yeah, nice play. That's the same exact play as the opening play, just obviously to the left side a little bit. And those kind of plays are great because it gets the defense a little bit on their heels, thinking, uh-oh, we better be prepared for this all night. Four-man front out there for those Lions. Keep your eyes out on River Young.
Miller under center. Again, Rapp goes in motion. Loses the football. It's down on the turf. Who's got it? Everybody's pointing. And we'll see who has the football. The Lions say they have it. The Bobcats say they have it. It looks like it's a Bobcat getting up the bottom of the pile. So Clarion area holds on to the football, and it's a big third down and 7 at midfield.
Yeah, McMaster, I believe, covered that football. And a big break there. Could have been disaster. Would have been serving the football up on a platter as the ball at the Lion 48-yard line. But it brings up now a third and a long 7.
Ball resting at the 48 of the Lions. Here come the Bobcats now, third down and 7. Miller working out of the shotgun. He's going to hand the football off in the backfield. And the quarterback actually kept the ball to the left side, and he's going to be sacked on the play, dropped on that far side. And a loss all the way back to the 45-yard line. They're going to say at the 50. Okay, they came with the one chain. They're going to say he was stopped at the 50-yard line. They give him his forward progress, but, Bob, that's still a loss of two, and it's fourth down and nine.
Yeah, great penetration by that defense. I thought maybe we might see a pass to Burford there on that far side because they were certainly giving Burford a little bit of a cushion.
Mills on.
Brings up a punt. River Young last week was pretty tough on those Bulldogs every time it came time to punt.
Hummel the deep man. There's the punt. They're going to angle it away from Hummel. He's going to let it bounce, and it's going to roll, and it's going to go out of bounds. What a punt that time.
It's a big time punt that time by Miller. Pins Lions back deep in their own territory.
So the Lions will start with their back against the wall here. Quarter number one, 8-0. Lions lead it. It is a Red Bank Chevrolet, our first quarter sponsor, and the Lions have it at their own 6-yard line. Lions lead here 8-0.
You know, that's when you got to be a little bit on the conservative side and certainly be cautious because, again, as you've got the ball on your own 6-yard line, not a lot of real estate to work with here if you do make a mistake.
And everybody was moving that time. The snap is out, but it looks like CL was able to get on top of it.
That time really not so much a bad snap, just a problem on the exchange and not sure whether it was the quarterback or the center on that one. But regardless, Lions do maintain possession.
Looks like no loss or gain on the play.
You know, I've been in those situations when you're back deep in your own territory. And
dead ball penalty.
False start. Oh, it was a false start.
Half the distance to the goal.
Well, that makes it even more of a challenge as they elect to go with the false start here, so half the distance. So now it makes it a first and 13 situation.
Ball resting at the three. The Lions come up to the football. It is a first and 13 for the Lions. McCray hands the football off. McAfee gets carrying a flag from one of the back judges here. We'll see what this one is as he was looking in.
Well, the flag actually definitely was from the back judge as he actually threw it over top of the Bobcats sideline. And it's kind of interesting that it's thrown that deep. But so what they're doing, actually, it's a sideline warning, so the official will pick up the flag. No, he's looking for it because he didn't know where exactly went. So,
well, the ball's out to the seven. It's a pickup of 4 yards on the play for him, second down and nine. Again, McAfee in the backfield. They got the twin backs in the backfield. Behind McCray, who comes under center, single receiver to the right side. And McCray looks to throw, fires down the left side. He's looking for his receiver. It's pulled in. Did he catch it? If he did, it's a great one too. And that was a Kyle Carley, and I think they're going to give him the catch. Oh, what a job by him as he laid out for that ball in the left sideline, and he pulls it in out near the 27-yard line.
Wow, a game by 20. Carley last week had a big catch and comes up with another big one, gets his team a lot of real estate, necessary real estate, if you will, here. As they're going to spot that, as Mike said, on the 27-yard line at 4:04.
That ball to 27. What a catch. And, of course, in high school and college, you just need to get the 1 foot in. And, well, he did not have a lot of room. And he got that 1 foot down. The Lions get out of a jam with their back against the wall. They're going to can the football off over the right side. It was that Wiles getting the carry on that. No, it was not Wiles. Let's see who it
that
was.
That actually was.
Was that Peace?
Chris Peace.
Yep, Peace getting his first carry of the ball game. And that's a loss on the play of about a yard back near the 26.
You know, that actually is a pretty smart play there by Peace because I think if he stands up a little bit, there were a host of Bobcat defenders. They're going to try and strip him of the ball. And, you know, sometimes the run just isn't there. Wise move by Peace. 3:30 on the clock here, opening quarter play. 8-0 Lion lead.
McCray works in the shotgun, looks to throw, fires the ball, batted down. Hit the line of scrimmage. That pass is batted down.
That is the first incomplete pass that time. And Tom Worster that time getting the arms up. I think he was more surprised than anything that the pass came that quick, but did a great job there. It was down lineman position.
Third down and 11, the ball to 26 of the Lions. Clarion Limestone leads 8-0. They've got the football, but a big third down. The Bobcat defense digging in. Here's McCray rolling around the right side. Finds his receiver, but he's hit and dropped. A big hit on the play as he's dropped for a loss back to the 22-yard line.
Wow.
And that's a loss of 5.
Yeah, Kyle Patterson delivering a clean shot, but wow. That was a painful one. You could feel that hit up here.
4th and 14 now. And the Lions will have to punt.
And remember, the Bobcats love to come after punts.
Here's the snap. Hummels punts on the way. Spiraling kick. Coming over to get it is McMaster. McMaster's going to pick it up, but he's on that end line. He's out of bounds. But good field position here for the Bobcats as they'll take over at their own 42-yard line. 8-0 as Clarion Limestone leads here. Quarter number one, 2:38 to go here in the quarter. And again, the first quarter brought to you by Red Bank Chevrolet.
Won't be too much longer until the scores will start and roll in here. And that's Zocro Motors scoreboard. And Mike changing glasses for the 88th time tonight.
I don't know. I'm trying to figure out which one I like better.
Well, you're advancing age. I'm sure that you'll come up with one. Right?
Yep. If not, I'll be back at the dollar store tomorrow.
He always spend the big money on this.
Well, the way I lose them.
And just after following this play, we'll start and take a good close look at that Zocro Motors scoreboard.
Miller will work out of the shotgun, twin, a single receiver on his side. He's going to run with the football. Looks a room to the right side, has it 45, 50, 45, to the 40, to the 35, and out of bounds goes Spencer Miller. And a first down here for the Bobcats as he takes it deep into Clarion Limestone territory at the 35-yard line.
Yeah, time, a 23-yard gain there out of Miller. And he's making it look easy with a run like that. Mike, as we look at that Zocro Motors scoreboard, it is Montas 7, Keystone 0. St. Mary's up 6-0 over Union AC Valley.
Bobcats with the football at the Clarion Limestone 37-yard line. Miller under center. Sends wrap in motion. They're going to give that ball, though, to McCloskey, and he's got a big hole. He's got it 20, 15 to the 10 to the 5 and into the end zone for the Clarion area. Touchdown. McCloskey will take that football 37 yards.
Once he got by that second wave, absolutely no chance. There is a late flag coming in here to sail into the play. I'm sure the touchdown will stand. We'll have to see what goes on with the flag, and I'm sure it was a couple of players just talking about tomorrow's activities, but we'll find out. That touchdown occurs to 2:23 mark. As the officials are talking to each other, and it appears that they are talking. They talked initially actually to both teams.
They might even be issuing a warning. Bob had lots of those issued on him in high school.
No, I was a good guy.
After the touchdown, unsportsmanlike conduct on the offense, 15-yard penalty will be assessed on the extra point.
So they will back the extra point up 15 yards because of an unsportsmanlike conduct on Clarion area after the touchdown.
Yeah, so now, literally, obviously, your only hope is to go for the two, and certainly the odds makers are not going to put a whole lot of faith in you at this point, as the ball is going to be at least a way back.
Yeah, all the way to the 18-yard line is where the ball rests. So the Bobcats will try for two here, but it's basically a red zone play because they're just inside the 20-yard line. We should have a microphone on Rossetti down there and see what happened. That's not a good idea.
Well, actually, he's sporting a fashionable look tonight as he's old-school Padres with that old-school Tony Gwynn jersey.
Well, here we go on the two-point conversion. They're going to dump the ball off across the middle of the field, looking for the end zone, and they're going to get it. They will get the two-point conversion. That is O'Reilly McMaster. As he got the catch, is there another flag?
Yeah.
And there is another flag on the play.
That was an extremely well-executed play. I'm not sure, again, about the penalty, but Bobcats are walking back, so that does not bode well for them. We'll sort it out. They walk over to the Lion captains.
Hold it.
And perhaps that's why it was so well-executed. Now they're going to march him back 10, but wow.
Yeah, the spot of the foul was down near the 4-yard line, so it takes it back to about the 14. So this extra point will start again, but they gained, about 4 yards on it. But I'm sure they'd rather much have the 2 points. Here we go. They'll get another shot. So 8-6 Lions lead, 2:23 is what remains in quarter number one. It's been a fun one so far. Miller is ready in the shotgun here for the two-point conversion. Now from the 14-yard line, the ball snapped back to him. Fires to the right side. Battle for the ball, and it's caught. The two-point conversion's good. And we'll see who came up with that catch for the Bobcats as the two-point conversion is good. I might have been McMaster again. And we'll get that for you. The Lions and the Bobcats are tied at 8 apiece. And we'll take a timeout. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, right here on exploreclarion.com.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs. Located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
Are you planning a party? Why not a pool party? Give them a party they will never forget at the Park Inn by Radisson. Right now, they are taking reservations for pool parties. You can book your party for any Sunday from 2 to 4 or from 5 to 7. Up to 25 people can attend. You can bring your own food, beverage, and cake. Who wouldn't want a poolside party? So throw a party with style at the Park Inn by Radisson. Just call 226-8850 to book your party today.
Looking for an apartment? Let Corsetti Rentals provide you with your housing needs. Come check out our townhouse rentals near Marianna Estates and on the east end of Clarion near Sheets and Clarion Ford. With student and non-student rentals located throughout the Clarion area, some within sight of Clarion University, and semester leases available too. Call Ron Corsetti Rentals at 226-8262, that's 226-8262, to schedule a showing.
Hey y'all, it's Lori from Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. RCBS reloading supplies are the best. We carry Charge Master combos, powder tricklers, hand priming tools, electronic and manual scales. Get the best RCBS reloading supplies at Route 66 Sporting Goods. Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. Located on Route 66, just north of Clarion, open 7 days a week. Call 814-226-4055 or visit us online at Route66SportingGoods.com.
Hi, this is Amy with S&W Auto Body in Lucinda. For over 25 years now, we have been providing auto body repair services for deer damage, collision, or your dings, dents, and scratches. We also install windshields, do general maintenance including oil changes, brakes, and state inspections. And for those of you who aren't car savvy, don't worry. Give us a call or stop in and we will talk you through your car issues to find the problem. S&W Auto Service Center, located on Shill Lane in Lucinda, where strangers are treated like friends and friends like family. 226-7046.
All right, back here at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. Boy, both crowds have had a chance to cheer tonight, and the Bobcats had to make a few attempts at that two-point conversion, but they finally get it to go.
You know, Mike, I'd have bet you a steak dinner that, based on the distance, wouldn't have happened. And I'll tell you, I'd have been paying you a steak dinner because not only did they make it once after the penalty, they had another chance, they made it again.
Mills sends it deep. And the return starts at about the 15 to the 20, to the 25. And that's McAfee taking it across the 30 and up to the 31-yard line.
Well, the game so far, we're at the 2:17 mark here in the opening quarter. It's 8-all, and it's really shaped up to everything we talked about this week and we expected. It has been a fun one so far.
Well, the Lions now find themselves knotted up here, 8-up.
Mike, there's been some outstanding offensive plays, some solid hits on the defensive side. Both teams have come up with some big-time hits.
Now, this is certainly the game that everybody wanted to see.
Reminds you a little bit of a heavyweight prize fight, if you will.
Carly, the slot man on the right side. Twins out there, single receiver to the left. McCray's under center. Swing pass gets it out to Ledbetter. Tries to make a move. Here's Ledbetter spinning out of one defender. Gets up to the 35. What a move by him. Up near the 37-yard line. Give him about 6 on the play. It sets up a second down here and 4 for the Lions.
Ledbetter, that's his first catch of the ball game. You know, Mike, we haven't talked about this at all, but what I find interesting is oftentimes these two teams not only would meet in the regular season, but guess what? Come playoff time they meet. Well, that's not going to happen this year, as Bobcats are double A and Lions class A, the new classification.
Lions tight at the line here. They're going to send one lone receiver. Actually, they're going to split to twins out to that left side. McCray fakes or gives that ball to McAfee. Gets out of one tackle. Tries to turn upfield. Does. And he'll be dropped for a loss on the play, though. He'll be dropped shy of that line of scrimmage by about a yard. So sets up a third down here. And 5-4 the Lions.
Yeah, at time McAfee looked like he'd be brought down for about a 2-3 yard loss. Somehow he's able to break free. Did lose a couple, but didn't lose the five that he potentially could have. So third and six situation now.
Yeah, they'll push him back to the 35-yard line. Again, the Lions working right to left here in quarter number one, down to 1 minute to go here in the quarter.
Tempo has slowed up just a bit here.
Twins on each side for McCray. Hands it off to McAfee. Tries to power up the middle. Breaks the tackle. Boy, does he get close to first down yardage. He'll be just short, I think. He needed the 41, but he's going to get like the 40-and-a-half-yard line. We'll see what the Lions decide to do. They're going to get up to the line of scrimmage quickly. It is fourth and about a half a yard is wherever that football is. They're going to go for it here. We're tied at eight. Fourth down and inches from their own 40-and-a-half-yard line. They need the 41, and they're going to keep that ball right up the gut. It was a direct snap. Is that a first down? It is. They're going to move the chains. Was that Hummel?
Yep, I believe it was.
So Hummel, that was that direct snap right to him, and it surprised everybody. And the Lions have a first down as McCray was back in shotgun.
Well, I can tell you they worked in practice all week. They already knew the players. Not a guy had to look towards the sideline,
nope.
Mike. They expected that to happen. That will be actually our last play here, the opening quarter.
All right, that'll do it for quarter number one. Again, brought to you by Red Bank Chevrolet. The score, 8-8. We're tied. New set of downs for the Lions. We come to quarter number two. We'll take a timeout. We're back with more after this. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, right here on exploreclarion.com.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs. Located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
Are you planning a party? Why not a pool party? Give them a party they will never forget at the Park Inn by Radisson. Right now, they are taking reservations for pool parties. You can book your party for any Sunday from 2 to 4 or from 5 to 7. Up to 25 people can attend. You can bring your own food, beverage, and cake. Who wouldn't want a poolside party? So throw a party with style at the Park Inn by Radisson. Just call 226-8850 to book your party today.
Looking for an apartment? Let Corsetti Rentals provide you with your housing needs. Come check out our townhouse rentals near Marianna Estates and on the east end of Clarion near Sheets and Clarion Ford. With student and non-student rentals located throughout the Clarion area, some within sight of Clarion University, and semester leases available too. Call Ron Corsetti Rentals at 226-8262. That's 226-8262 to schedule a showing.
Hey y'all, it's Lori from Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. RCBS reloading supplies are the best. We carry Charge Master combos, powder tricklers, hand priming tools, electronic and manual scales. Get the best RCBS reloading supplies at Route 66 Sporting Goods. Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. Located on Route 66, just north of Clarion, open 7 days a week. Call 814-226-4055 or visit us online at Route66SportingGoods.com.
Hi, this is Amy with S&W Auto Body in Lucinda. For over 25 years now, we have been providing auto body repair services for deer damage, collision, or your dings, dents, and scratches. We also install windshields, do general maintenance including oil changes, brakes, and state inspections. And for those of you who aren't car savvy, don't worry. Give us a call or stop in and we will talk you through your car issues to find the problem. S&W Auto Service Center, located on Shill Lane in Lucinda, where strangers are treated like friends and friends like family. 226-7046.
All right, back here at Clarion's Memorial Stadium, Mike Kalinowski, the Governor, Bob Dunkel with you. What a night here at Memorial Stadium, the Backyard Brawl. It is the Black and Blue Brawl now as the big trophy getting ready to go to the winner.
Now, Mike, if the rest of the ball game keeps this pace, number one, I'm going to need another pen, so I hope you packed extra.
Yes, I do.
Number We're two, good. You may, hey, your voice may get a little tired.
I travel college football with Joe Ludnowski. You got to come with everything. All napkins and snacks and pens.
Somehow I can believe that.
We switch sides of the football field. Lions with the football, so we switch sides of the field. Quarter number two, handed off here. Wiles gets the carry this time. And he'll be dropped for a one-yard pickup up to the 48-yard line. Give him one. Second down and nine. Second quarter brought to you by Hager Paving. Hager Paving in Strattonville. Don just visited the booth. You got a chance to say hi. Always. He's all over.
He's a very popular kind of guy. And the Lions, again, Mike had talked about, they've slowed things down a little bit. There's nothing wrong with that. Get everybody on the same page. I think, you know, you're at that point in the ballgame where you're really not going to catch anybody off guard.
Callen wide out to the left. It's Ledbetter out to the right. The backs of the I formation. McCray looks to throw. Pumps once. Fires. He's got his receiver down the right side. They're looking for it. It's picked off. It's intercepted by Miller. He's to the 30, 35, 40, 45, 50 to the 45-yard line and then tiptoes out of bounds. The ball was just a little underthrown, and Miller was there to take it away. And the Bobcats have the football in business.
Yeah, I think the interception will still stand. There is a flag down. I think that occurred on the return. Is that flag somewhere around the area of about the 50, 49-yard line?
After the interception, holding on the return team.
So they'll back it up.
Not a very popular call with the crowd in front of us, but
Bobcats have been flagged a few times tonight already.
And the official, again, you know, threw the flag very early. No hesitation on it. So at 11:13, the Bobcats will set up shop here, looking to take advantage, capitalize. One of my keys, Mike, was to capitalize on the turnovers. Here's a golden opportunity for him. Got the football in outstanding position.
Of course, as Larry Weiser gets this win tonight, it's win number 200 in his career, a milestone.
Almost as many wins as you are years old, right?
That's right. Burford wide out to the right. Miller under center. They're going to hand that football off over the right side and running with that football. That is Zerfoss, I believe, over the right side as he's going to be hit and dropped. No gain on the play. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage at the 43. Yep. So no gain, second down and 10.
And I like what the Bobcats have done here in offense. They're showing some multiple looks as far as getting other guys involved in the ball game. You know the bread and butter back there is really with Rapp and McCluskey.
Ball at the 43-yard line of the Bobcats as they work the ball near midfield. 8-8, we're tied here at Memorial Stadium right here on exploreclarion.com. Backs will line up in the I formation. Miller will come under center. They got the wide out to the left side. They're going to hand that football off, and that's a wrap. And Rapp lowers the shoulder, and he'll take that football forward, and he'll pick up good yardage across midfield into the 49-yard line of Clarion Limestone. Sets up a third down here in about two. So gain of 8 on the play.
They give him 31 yards in the ball game. Just a simple run right up the gut. Offensive line to an air part to surge forward. Rapp runs very low to the ground, so it makes him a very difficult kind of guy to tackle.
Well, resting just beyond the 49-yard line of the Lions, they're going to hand that ball off. A little belly play, getting the carry this time was the blocking back, and it's a first down as they'll take it down near the 45-yard line. I think that was McCloskey getting the carry.
They're going to peel an awful lot of players, get to the bottom of that pile. And it is McCloskey.
Yep, he got off the bottom. So a first down. They needed two. They're going to gain about four, and it is a first down here for the Bobcats. Tied at 8. The Bobcats now on the Clarion Limestone side of the football field. Second quarter, 9:35 to go on the turning clock. Perfect night here tonight. What a crowd, two on hand. I think all is Strattonville and quite a bit of Clarion are here. The ball snapped back. Here's Miller rolling to the left side and whistles blow. The play dead, and is there a timeout before? Is there a penalty?
There is a penalty.
Saw the flag now. Should be a procedure.
Dead ball penalty. False start on the offense.
So they'll back up Clarion area.
First down.
They'll back him up to midfield. Sets up a first and 15 here for the Bobcats.
9:24 on the clock here. It's an 8-all ball game. It's been a lot of fun so far.
But more scores coming in. Make sure you stay tuned. We'll check that Zockrell Motor scoreboard as we go through. Bobcats break the huddle, and they come up to the line of scrimmage at midfield. Miller under center. Klosky in the backfield. They're going to send Rapp in motion. They're going to pitch the ball to Rapp. They try to swing it over to the left side. He tries to cut upfield. He gets out of one tackle. He's to the 45, flag on the play. 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, and he's hitting out of bounds right around the 20-yard line, but a flag, and I think you're going to see this one come back.
I would be surprised if it doesn't come back. Generally, looked like there might have been a hold on the one side, but we'll let the officials sort it out. While they do that, Mike, we're going to take a look here at that Zockrell Motors scoreboard. Carn City up 20-0 over Punxsie. Red Bank Valley on top of Brookville 7-0. That in quarter number two.
Incidental face mask on the defense. That'll be a 5-yard penalty.
Oh, okay. I thought we might have had a hold, but the face mask, the incidental will be called, and they're going to take the play. And it will be down at the 20-yard line. Then they'll mark off the incidental. And it will go down to the 15. So they are in the M&B Ready Mix red zone. Are these Bobcats as they try to take a lead here in the second quarter? We're tied at 8.
As we continue to look at Zockrell Motors scoreboard, it is Montauk 13, Keystone 6. Central Mountain 7, Clearfield 7, St. Mary's 12, Union AC Valley 0.
Miller rolls to the right side, looks to run. Here's Miller to the 10. Miller tries to look for room with the 5, first down. Reaches out for the pylon. Does he get it? The official, no signal yet. They're going to say, is he short?
They're going to say he stepped out of bounds, actually, just at that 4-yard line. He was tiptoeing down the sidelines.
Because he kept the play going, and we weren't sure, of course, on the far sideline. So it is a first and goal. They're going to be down, Bob said, at about the 4.
And Fisher right on top of it. Easy call for him to make. He's in prime position. We couldn't tell from our vantage point.
8:47 remaining here in the quarter. Again, we have the Route 66 Sporting Goods halftime show coming up here in this Black and Blue Brawl 2016. They're going to come with the power package in the backfield. The trip backs are going to hand the ball off to Rapp, and Rapp's hit, and he's going to be brought down shy of the goal line. They'll give him the 2.
And I thought we might see a procedure penalty, and that looked like some of the offense moved a little bit early, but the official felt otherwise. And you know what? They're down at the top of it. I guess you know, much better vantage point, certainly, than what we do. Other scores from that Zockrell Motors scoreboard is Brockway 14, Ridgeway 2. That in quarter number 2, K-9, Kerwinsville 0. That at the start of the second quarter.
Ball to 2-yard line. Here come the Bobcats now. Miller's under center. Loses the football. It's down on the turf. And who's got it? The Bobcats will recover the fumble back at the 5-yard line. That was Rapp on top of the football.
Yeah, good heads-up play that time by Rapp. That football came squirting out, and it looks like we're going to have a timeout here, Michael.
There will be a timeout on the football field. We'll take 1-2, 7:58 to go. Here in the first half, the Bobcats will have a 3rd and goal from the 6-yard line after this timeout. And you're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, right here on exploreclarion.com.
Look no further than the Loomis for great food, drinks, and service. Featuring certified Angus steaks, classic pastas, hometown favorites, and of course, our incredible Loomis pizza. Free delivery to businesses during lunch. The Loomis Bar features pizza and wing specials and live music Saturday nights. Let us host your next event at the Loomis in one of our spacious banquet facilities. The Loomis. Like the Loomis on Facebook for daily specials and events or call 226-8400.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist, savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leeper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Hometown spirit, nothing else comes near it.
Our roots are right here in this area. We're local. Many of us were born and raised in the hometowns that we serve. Some places have local branches. We have local roots. First United National Bank, the Fun Bank, member FDIC. Online at fun-bank.com.
It's the kind of pride that you feel inside. We've got the hometown spirit.
The Cooper Tire Take the Money and Ride event is back this fall. Whether you're ready to tailgate or take a scenic drive, you can get the right tires and a reward of up to $70 with the purchase of a new set of four qualifying tires through October 31st. It's the perfect way to get your car ready for the season and score up to a $70 prepaid card by mail when you purchase a new set of four all-terrain Discover AT3s, pavement-gripping Cooper Xeon RS3 G1s, or other qualifying Cooper tires. Carling Tire, the area's largest selection of tires.
He's on the 30, he's on the 20, he's on the 10, it's a touchdown!
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools.
Clarion County Community Bank. A better way to bank. Member FDIC. Visit us online at clarionbank.com.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
All right, back here at Memorial Stadium. Good to see the player walking off under his own power after the injury down there. Bobcats and the Lions tonight. Bobcats have the football. They are at the 5, make it to 6-yard line after the fumble on the snap. So here come the Bobcats. It's 3rd and goal from the 6-yard line. Clarion area comes set now. Here's Miller working out of the shotgun. He's going to fake to Rapp. Rolls to the right side. He's looking to throw. He's got a receiver. It's caught. Touchdown. Touchdown. And he'll get it to McCloskey in the end zone. 6 yards, and the Bobcats take the lead.
It's just a nice little simple rollout out of that shotgun formation as McCloskey pulls that one in.
Second touchdown here of the evening for McCloskey.
You know, they allowed, the big key there, Mike, was allowing time for the play to develop. Now the Bobcats are lined up out of that Oklahoma shift. It appears that they will attempt the extra point on this one.
Yeah, Mills is on for the extra point try. Here's the snap, the hold. No, the hold gets away, and that's going to do it right there. The extra point is no good, and that will make it a 14-8 ball game as the Lions and the Bobcats doing battle here at Memorial Stadium in this black and blue brawl. 7:45 remains in the first half. We'll take a timeout, and you're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, right here on exploreClarion.com.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community's need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins Road in Clarion. Call us toll-free at 1-800-262-2118.
Attention all car buyers. The biggest year-end clear the lot blowout is happening this month at Clarion Ford. All 2016s must go, and Clarion Ford will give you your best deal along with 0% up to 72 months financing during the Ford Freedom Sales event. And find fantastic year-end prices on all 2016 Ford F-150s, America's best-selling truck for 39 years, and get 0% for 72 months or over $5,000 in factory rebates and bonus cash. Remember, nobody beats a Clarion Ford deal. Nobody. Clarion Ford, East Main Street, Clarion.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving. Did you know the average in-state public college is $20,800 per year and a private school averages over $45,000? Are you prepared to help your child or grandchild go to college? There are many savings options and tax incentives for you to consider. We can help you create a college savings plan. Visit JannieClarion.com to learn more or call us at 223-9990. Jannie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist: savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs. Located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
All right, back here at Memorial Stadium, getting set for the kickoff. And Mills will send it down the field. McAfee comes up, takes it at the 16 to the 20. He's to the 25. He's to the 30-yard line and dropped it about the 31. And that's where the Lions will have the football.
Yeah, good coverage that time on special teams. As the Lions forced to set up shop here, 741. We're number two. Great to have you with us. Fantastic night.
Oh, it's beautiful. Absolutely. I'm happy I wore the shorts, too.
I'll go ahead and rub it in. That's okay.
You can cut your pants off. I got scissors.
I'm financially challenged. We
cannot
waste.
Oh, you're challenged, but not financially.
Yes, I am.
Lions with the football. Here is quarter number two, again brought to you by Hager Paving in Strattonville.
My last name's not Kalinowski. I'm a very poor man.
Yeah.
Life of poor man's not an easy one.
And McCray rolls to the right side, looks to throw wide open. That is Callen in the middle of the football field, and he just can't find him. Oh, Callen got behind the defense, and he was wide open, but it falls incomplete.
Yeah, that's one of those situations there where I don't know that you can outrun the arm strength of McCray based on what I've seen, Mike. I think just tell him, hey, you throw as far as you can, let me run underneath it.
Ball resting back at the 31-yard line here for the Lions. Boy, they had, I don't know. Callen's a pretty tall kid. I don't know if he would race some of those smaller guys, but he could drag them.
Well, you know, remember last week he had a gainer of 70 yards.
So yeah, that's true, too.
He didn't score, but he had a 70-yard reception.
He'll come back out wide to the right in the slot. That's Ledbetter on the right side. McCray comes under center. McAfee in the backfield. It's a second down here in 10. They're going to send Hummel, and they're going to fire the ball, and the ball's batted down at that line of scrimmage as he tried to get it over there.
You know, and that's the second time, actually. Tom Worcester doing a great job. He's 6'3", 214, got a long wingspan. He's blocked a couple of passes tonight, and he was in the right position. You know, sometimes as a lineman, one of your jobs, too, is just create traffic. Did a great job with that. Bats the ball down, brings up the third in the full 10 situation now.
Yeah. You, go ahead.
You would think it's an apparent passing down, but with McAfee back there, we just very well could see a run. Could be a real estate play.
I'm just not used to seeing that 89 on the line. I keep looking at him like, what's the receiver doing out there? Here we go. It's a third down and 10 from the 31. They're going to hand that ball off to McAfee, and he's dropped for a loss on the play back near the 27-yard line. That'll be a loss of close to four. And it will be a fourth down, and we'll see a punt coming up here for the Lions. And they will send, see who they send back here. Usually that's a McMaster.
Yep, Riley McMaster back deep on the return here for the Bobcats. Remember, they love to apply pressure on these punts.
McMaster stands back at his 47. Hummel to punt. Good snap to him, and not a whole lot of pressure. Hummel gets a good punt away. McMaster comes up. He'll take it, takes the knee, and at about the 46-yard line.
And that time it was a late fair catch signal. Yeah, some of the crowd wants a penalty, but
nothing
you
there.
Won't see that. And it wasn't a, wasn't a vicious one.
And they're going to come over.
You know, and sometimes we've seen this over the years too. Sometimes the official doesn't always feel that it's a true fair catch signal. The official will come to the sideline and chit-chat for a few seconds. And coaching staff nods in agreement. They understand why there was no call. Really, I think the crowd got a little more excited about it than what
and
it
they usually do. We've been around a long time.
Speak for yourself. I'm just a rookie at this
point. Oh, jeez. You're older than I am. Here we go. Miller keeps the football, and he's hit. Gets out of a couple tackles, spins around, and gets back up near the line of scrimmage. Good job by Miller, though, to get back to the line of scrimmage. He was down probably a couple yards behind, and no gain on the play, second down and 10.
Miller that time doing a good job of tiptoeing everything. Looked like he'd be stopped for about a yard loss, and he's able to spin a little bit. Gets back to that original line of scrimmage. Clock continues to run here as Bobcats up in this one 14-8 here at the 6:21 mark. Quarter number two, great to have you with us.
Ball resting at the 46-yard line here for the Bobcats. Second down and 10. They're on their own side of the football field. Miller pitches it back, and that's Rapp getting the carry to the 50, to the 45-40, to the 35-30, 25-20, to the 15, to the 10, and he's drug out of bounds inside that 10-yard line as he's in the M&B Ready Mix red zone. And it'll be a first and goal for the Bobcats out near the 13-yard line.
Well, they can still pick up a first down after that long run, Mike. But
you're right. That's right. Getting ahead of myself. And it happens. So it sets up a first 10 and 10 from the 13-yard line. But they are in that M&B Ready Mix red zone.
Yeah, that time, Mike, a gain of 37 yards. Or excuse me, actually 41 yards.
Miller under center. They're going to hand that football off. McCloskey banging up the middle, and they're trying to push him forward. And he'll get a couple yards down near the 12-yard line. Give him a couple and sets up a second down here in 8.
Yeah, I really like this combination between McCloskey and Rapp. You know, these guys are physical guys. They're going to punish you. They're going to hit you. Offensive line doing a very good job that time. Defensive line rising to the occasion, preventing a short gain. Clock now down to 5:29. This would be huge to score here for the Bobcats.
Miller's under center. In motion goes Rapp. They're going to pitch the ball to Rapp. He tries to swing it to the outside on the right side, tries to turn upfield. He's met, spinning, and he'll get near the marker. He gets down near about the 5-yard line. We'll see where they put the football. It depends where the official says he went out. And where the official is standing, he should have the first down. Well, nope, he's back at the 5. Makes it a third and about 1 is what it's going to be, Bob. The one official on the far side had taken the ball near the first down marker, but the other one says no, it's back at the five.
You got to be thinking here, four down territory regardless, but.
Ball sitting at the five. It is a third and one. Miller under center. Takes the snap, hands it off, right up the gut they go. Good push toward the goal line. Do they get down? They're going to be stopped at the one. It'll be a first and goal now for the Bobcats at the one. And they're going to say touchdown now. A really delayed call by the official, and I believe that was McCloskey getting it. That is, as he'll come over toward the sideline, that is a touchdown for the Bobcats. That's about as long or late of a call as you're going to get.
Well, let's just say that everybody wanted to make sure that was the right call as he goes in from 5 yards out. Well, Mike, he has been a part of every single score except the conversion tonight for Clarion area.
And a timeout will be taken. Offense. On the two-point conversion or the one-point conversion, we'll see. We'll take a quick timeout, too. We'll come back. We've got the extra point coming up. It is now 20-8 in favor of Clarion area. The extra point on the way right after this. And you're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, and it's right here on exploreclarion.com.
Are you planning a party? Why not a pool party? Give them a party they will never forget at the Park Inn by Radisson. Right now, they are taking reservations for pool parties. You can book your party for any Sunday from 2 to 4 or from 5 to 7. Up to 25 people can attend. You can bring your own food, beverage, and cake. Who wouldn't want a poolside party? So throw a party with style at the Park Inn by Radisson. Just call 226-8850 to book your party today.
Looking for an apartment? Let Corsetti Rentals provide you with your housing needs. Come check out our townhouse rentals near Marianna States and on the east end of Clarion near Sheets and Clarion Ford. With student and non-student rentals located throughout the Clarion area, some within sight of Clarion University, and semester leases available too. Call Ron Corsetti Rentals at 226-8262, that's 226-8262, to schedule a showing.
Hey y'all, it's Lori from Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. RCBS reloading supplies are the best. We carry Chargemaster combos, powder tricklers, hand priming tools, electronic and manual scales. Get the best RCBS reloading supplies at Route 66 Sporting Goods. Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. Located on Route 66, just north of Clarion, open 7 days a week. Call 814-226-4055 or visit us online at Route66SportingGoods.com.
Hi, this is Amy with S&W Auto Body in Lucinda. For over 25 years now, we have been providing auto body repair services for deer damage, collision, or your dings, dents, and scratches. We also install windshields, do general maintenance including oil changes, brakes, and state inspections. And for those of you who aren't car savvy, don't worry. Give us a call or stop in and we will talk you through your car issues to find the problem. S&W Auto Service Center, located on Shill Lane in Lucinda, where strangers are treated like friends and friends like family. 226-7046.
All right, back at Memorial Stadium, we're getting set for the extra point try here by the Bobcats. And they're going to go for the two-point conversion. Here's Miller under center. They're going to take the snap. They're going to keep it. Does Miller, and he's got all kinds of room on the left side. He scores 22-8 as the Bobcats lead the Lions. 4:56 remains here in the first half. And we'll pause one more time. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, folks, and it's right here on ExploreClarion.com.
Look no further than the Loomis for great food, drinks, and service. Featuring certified Angus steaks, classic pastas, hometown favorites, and, of course, our incredible Loomis pizza. Free delivery to businesses during lunch. The Loomis Bar features pizza and wing specials and live music Saturday nights. Let us host your next event at the Loomis in one of our spacious banquet facilities. The Loomis. Like the Loomis on Facebook for daily specials and events, or call 226-8400.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist, savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Hometown spirit, nothing else comes near it.
Our roots are right here in this area. We're local. Many of us were born and raised in the hometowns that we serve. Some places have local branches. We have local roots. First United National Bank, the Fun Bank, member FDIC. Online at fun-bank.com.
It's the kind of pride that you feel inside. We've got the hometown spirit.
The Cooper Tire Take the Money and Ride event is back this fall. Whether you're ready to tailgate or take a scenic drive, you can get the right tires and a reward of up to $70 with the purchase of a new set of four qualifying tires through October 31st. It's the perfect way to get your car ready for the season and score up to a $70 prepaid card by mail when you purchase a new set of four all-terrain Discover AT3s, pavement-gripping Cooper Xeon RS3 G1s, or other qualifying Cooper tires. Carling Tire, the area's largest selection of tires.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
He's on the 30, he's on the 20, he's on the 10, it's a touchdown!
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools.
Clarion County Community Bank, a better way to bank. Member FDIC. Visit us online at clarionbank.com.
All right, back at Memorial Stadium in Clarion. It is the KSAC game of the week. Here's the kickoff. Get a bounce. It gets past Hummel, and he's going to come back and pick it up at his 16-yard line. Comes upfield 20, 25, and he loses the football, and it looks like the Bobcats get it back. The ball is knocked down, and Clarion area will get the football back at the 32-yard line.
Excellent job on the special teams that time. I'm not sure who put the hit on, but fumble recovery clearly handled by the Bobcats, and they are in the driver's seat right now, looking to capitalize on that.
And that was Archer Mills, your kicker, on the recovery.
So Mills, as you heard in the background, Mike Stallman on the PA, Archer Mills getting the recovery as he followed that play.
Yeah, great job that time. Normally the kicker serves as the safety, doesn't come down that deep on the football field. Time, right place, right play. Even better result if you're a Bobcat fan. Now the defense here for the Lions looking to come up, make a big play here. As Bobcats break the huddle.
Lions scored on the first drive of the game. They led 8-0, but it's been all Bobcats. They show blitz. In motion goes McMaster. And Miller is going to be hit as he takes the snap. And who comes out with the football? Hummel does come out with the football, but they're going to say Miller was down. And they're going to give him progress back to about the 38-yard line. That'll be a loss of 7 on the play as, boy, the Lions showed blitz, and they came flying.
Yeah, that time. Yeah, no question about the blitz that time as Miller just stood. He had absolutely no chance to react whatsoever. So he's going to lose the 7 on that. Still has 30 yards rushing in the ball game tonight, Mike.
Ball back at the 38-yard line here for the Bobcats. It's a second down here and about 18. The ball handed off and getting the carry. Rapp, not a whole lot there. He'll get back near the 35-yard line, give him 3 yards on the carry, and it sets up a third down now. Third down at about 13.
Rapp has
3rd and 13.
Rapp has 104 yards here in the ball game. He's had a whole lot of success just about any time he touches the football.
Yeah, they're
good, hard-nosed runner.
Yes, he is. Ball, they're going to say, was actually down at the 36-yard line. So sets up a third down and 15 here for
I'm surprised
the
they've
Bobcats.
Not tried to get the ball into the hands of Burford. Burford with that height.
And again, that was Miller with the football as he tried to roll to the left side, and the Lions are there to get him again. How about that? They're going to push him back near the 45-yard line. That's a loss of 10 on the play. Big McAfee back there to get the tackle.
Yep, you could see the blitz being set up from the word go. Now, normally you would say, okay, well, you know, it's four down territory. Not so much now, I don't think, of this call, because that drops the ball all the way back to the 45. We would have to get down to the 21 to pick up a first down, so you'd need 24. So it is a punting situation.
Humble back.
Good chance here to pin the Lions back deep as well.
Here's a snap. It's a good one. Punts away by Miller. Angles it to the right side. Hummel comes up, takes it at the 10. He's to the 15. Hummel shakes a tackle to the 20, to the 25, to the 30, and up near the 32-yard line. That's where the Lions will have the football. We got to, what, about 2:32 to go here in this quarter. It is 22-8 in favor of the Bobcats, but the Lions with the football.
Yeah, it's a good example, one of those fumbles that does not come back to haunt you that time. Good play out there by the defense, rising to the occasion, making some big-time sacks. So they get the ball back really, actually, to be quite honest, where they would have started out had they not fumbled the kick. So the 2:32 on the clock now, so there's not a lot of time. A lot depends how aggressive you're going to be, really, and what happens on this down right here. If you experience success, I think you'll be aggressive. If not, you'll be content to trail by two scores.
Split twins to the right, single receiver to the left. McCray works out of the shotgun. They're going to send Ledbetter in motion right to left this time. He'll come set on that right side, on that left side. McCray flushed out of the pocket. He's hit, dropped. He had nowhere to go, and he slides down. They're going to give him.
Well, there's a penalty flag in the play, and I think actually I would take the result of the play rather than march him up and give him the five. That's an illegal motion because the receiver that time cut up the field too quickly.
It's a 7-yard loss on the sack. It would only be a 5-yard penalty, you're right, Bob, so they'll take it. Sets up a second down here in 17. And
That time makes it a little tough. As he's got all kinds of fans that pay him visits up here.
Well, you know.
Here I just sit like that disappointing neighbor you have to deal with. Occasionally.
Oh, that's kind of true. I'm kidding.
No, I resemble that remark. I understand.
McCray works out of the shotgun, single receiver on his side. Ledbetter in motion this time. McCray looks to throw, fires the football to the right side. No one's looking, and the pass is out of bounds. And way out of bounds. It was picked off, but out of bounds. Ty Burford was over there, but third down now. That'll stop the clock.
You know, I'm not sure what all defensive adjustments the Bobcats have made out there, but I've got to tell you, McCray started out 4-for-4, had the one touchdown. He was 4-for-4, 67 yards. Right now he has a total of 11 attempts. So the next seven, he is only 2-of-7 with one interception.
Yeah.
So obviously some big changes there, and there's a lot of more pressure, I think, that defensive line being very aggressive.
Lions are going to go 5 wide here. Low snap. McCray picks it up, tries to get the screen set up, and he does, and it is caught, but nothing doing. As coming up with a catch, it's Kyle Carley, but a short gain of only about 2 out to the 28-yard line. And it's fourth down, and now the Lions are going to have to punt with still 1:40 on the clock here.
And I was surprised that Coach Weiser didn't look at a timeout to keep some of that time on the clock. There's 17 now on the play clock. There's 1:27 on the game clock.
I'm going to punt. Back deep, that is McMaster. Punts away, it's blocked. The punt is blocked. And it's going to be picked up at about the 32. Ball still out, and the Lions fall on top of it. It won't matter. It is Clarion's football, and it'll be out around the 32, 33-yard line.
Yeah. The officials now will set up shop, and they're saying, yes, indeed, Michael is Bobcat football. They'll get the chain set here. Great field position. It's balling out to 32-yard line. 1:12 on the clock. This would be huge to score right here if you're a Bobcat. The defense now has really got to step up. Here by the Bobcats.
Bobcats are tight at the line. They're going to pitch the ball back to Rapid. Almost got behind him, but he scoops it in. Now he's to the 30. He's got room. 25-20 to the 15 to the 10. Cuts back to the right. He's hit inside the 5. It'll be a first and goal down near the 2-yard line. Make it the 3 for the Bobcats as they look to add on here with a minute 2 to go here in this first half.
That'll give Rapp 133 yards rushing here in the first half.
Let's go!
He couldn't keep up behind him. That time as he's able to reel that football in.
Miller under center, takes the snap, hands the football off. McCloskey right up the gut he goes. And he's down near the goal line. No signal. Finally, another signal here. Touchdown for the Bobcats. They get another one.
And that's McCloskey with the ball
carry. McCloskey getting his fourth touchdown. That one goes 3 yards on the scamper.
And good. You know, one of my keys, I felt that special teams are going to come up big in this one, and they have. Just recently able to block that punt.
So the Lions come onto the football field. It is second down here and 3. As Bob said, 35 ticks on the clock left here in the first half. Coach Weiser seeking his 200th win here in this Black and Blue Brawl 2016. And the big trophy getting set to be given away to the winner. Bob will be down there for that presentation. McCray will work out of the shotgun. Looks to throw. has good protection, fires across the middle, and it's caught by Ledbetter. He's at the 30. Ledbetter gets out of that tackle to the 25, and Ledbetter out of bounds on the far side of the field at about the 21-yard line, and that's with 26 seconds still on the clock. He got out of bounds, and that should stop the clock as they move the chains.
And what a good job that time, as just like that, this offense really has picked up, able to make some conversions.
Lions come to the line of scrimmage as they're driving here late in this first half. Bobcats digging in defensively. Here's McCray out of the shotgun, looking to throw again. Again has protection. Fires down the left side, looking up for the ball. It's incomplete. Trying to find Callen over there, but it's incomplete to him. So second down and 10 from the 21 of the Bobcats for the Lions. 20 seconds to go. 28-8, the Bobcats late lead. Boy, the Lions would love nothing more than to get points on the board going in at halftime here.
Yep, and based where they're at in the field, if there would be an interception or something, it's not going to come back really to haunt you because you're throwing pretty deep here to begin with. You're deep in Bobcat territory. The offense has really set up shop at the 21-yard line.
They're going to split Carly to the left side, off to the right side, twin receivers. McCray out of the shotgun. He's looking to the right side. Now back to the left. Now steps up into the pocket. He's flushed out. Fires toward the end zone. And the ball sails. And it's almost intercepted. Almost picked off down there by Burford. But it's incomplete. So third down and 10. 13 seconds on the clock. The way they're playing, they could still get two more plays. And yeah. Two timeouts.
Oh, you're right. Now, obviously, this is where it's great to have. You've got the timeouts to work with. Should you pick up a first down, of course, the clock's going to stop very quickly. Certainly have a veteran clock keeper here.
Ball resting at the 21-yard line. Third and 10 here for the Lions on the Bobcat side of the football field. McCray firing toward the end zone. He's got a receiver fighting for the ball, and it's incomplete. They're going to say no catch down there as it bounces away.
They got the look they wanted. The coverage was nice and tight. The ball just goes incomplete. Now 6 seconds is all likelihood will be the final play here of the first half.
And that was on that far side. Just want to make sure I was right. That was Carly on that far side, the intended receiver. We do have a timeout to get on the field. Why don't we take a quick break, too? We're back with the final few seconds here in this second quarter. And the Bobcats lead at 28-8. Back with more on the KSAC Game of the Week on the Triple R Roadhouse, sponsored by the Triple R Roadhouse, right here on exploreclarion.com.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins Road in Clarion. Call us toll-free at 1-800-262-2118.
Attention all car buyers. The biggest year-end clear the lot blowout is happening this month at Clarion Ford. All 2016s must go, and Clarion Ford will give you your best deal along with 0% up to 72 months financing during the Ford Freedom Sales event. And find fantastic year-end prices on all 2016 Ford F-150s, America's best-selling truck for 39 years. And get 0% for 72 months or over $5,000 in factory rebates and bonus cash. Remember, nobody beats a Clarion Ford deal. Nobody. Clarion Ford, East Main Street, Clarion.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
Did you know? know the average in-state public college is $20,800 per year and a private school averages over $45,000? Are you prepared to help your child or grandchild go to college? There are many savings options and tax incentives for you to consider. We can help you create a college savings plan. Visit JannieClarion.com to learn more or call us at 223-9990. Jannie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist: savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs. Located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
All right, back at Memorial Stadium. Timeout over for the Lions. Here we go to the line of scrimmage. It's fourth down and 10. Lions trail. McCray looks to throw, flushed out of the pocket, spinning around. Now he steps back up, looking to throw the football, fires the football toward the end zone. He's got two receivers. It's batted away by Burford at the very last second. He had a receiver behind him, and it's incomplete. And that will end the first half. What a first half, too. The Bobcats lead at 28-8, but it's been entertaining as the Bobcats and Lions doing battle here in this black and blue brawl, and we'll take a timeout. We'll come back. We have the Route 66 Sporting Goods Halftime Show coming up.
Are you planning a party? Why not a pool party? Give them a party they will never forget at the Park Inn by Radisson. Right now, they are taking reservations for pool parties. You can book your party for any Sunday from 2 to 4 or from 5 to 7. Up to 25 people can attend. You can bring your own food, beverage, and cake. Who wouldn't want a poolside party? So throw a party with style at the Park Inn by Radisson. Just call 226-8850 to book your party today.
Looking for an apartment? Let Corsetti Rentals provide you with your housing needs. Come check out our townhouse rentals near Marianna Estates and on the east end of Clarion near Sheets and Clarion Ford. With student and non-student rentals located throughout the Clarion area, some within sight of Clarion University, and semester leases available too. Call Ron Corsetti Rentals at 226-8262. That's 226-8262 to schedule a showing.
Hey y'all, it's Lori from Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. RCBS reloading supplies are the best. We carry Charge Master combos, powder tricklers, hand priming tools, electronic and manual scales. Get the best RCBS reloading supplies at Route 66 Sporting Goods. Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. Located on Route 66, just north of Clarion, open 7 days a week. Call 814-226-4055 or visit us online at Route66SportingGoods.com.
Hi, this is Amy with S&W Auto Body in Lucinda. For over 25 years now, we have been providing auto body repair services for deer damage, collision, or your dings, dents, and scratches. We also install windshields, do general maintenance including oil changes, brakes, and state inspections. And for those of you who aren't car savvy, don't worry. Give us a call or stop in and we will talk you through your car issues to find the problem. S&W Auto Service Center, located on Shill Lane in Lucinda, where strangers are treated like friends and friends like family. 226-7046.
Look no further than the Loomis for great food, drinks, and service. Featuring certified Angus steaks, classic pastas, hometown favorites, and of course, our incredible Loomis pizza. Free delivery to businesses during lunch. The Loomis Bar features pizza and wing specials and live music Saturday nights. Let us host your next event at the Loomis in one of our spacious banquet facilities. The Loomis. Like the Loomis on Facebook for daily specials and events, or call 226-8400.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist, savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Look no further than the Loomis for great food, drinks, and service. Featuring certified Angus steaks, classic pastas, hometown favorites, and of course, our incredible Loomis pizza. Free delivery to businesses during lunch. The Loomis Bar features pizza and wing specials and live music Saturday nights. Let us host your next event at the Loomis in one of our spacious banquet facilities. The Loomis. Like the Loomis on Facebook for daily specials and events, or call 226-8400.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist, savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Hometown spirit, nothing else comes near it.
Our roots are right here in this area. We're local. Many of us were born and raised in the hometowns that we serve. Some places have local branches. We have local roots. First United National Bank, the Fun Bank, member FDIC. Online at fun-bank.com.
It's the kind of pride that you feel inside. We've got the hometown spirit.
The Cooper Tire Take the Money and Ride event is back this fall. Whether you're ready to tailgate or take a scenic drive, you can get the right tires and a reward of up to $70 with the purchase of a new set of four qualifying tires through October 31st. It's the perfect way to get your car ready for the season and score up to a $70 prepaid card by mail when you purchase a new set of four all-terrain Discover AT3s, pavement-gripping Cooper Xeon RS3 G1s, or other qualifying Cooper tires. Carly Tire, the area's largest selection.
the rock band Led Zeppelin. Sit back and relax as the band plays Cashmere.
Evening.
owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
He's on the 30. He's on the 20. He's on the 10. It's a touchdown!
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools. Clarion County Community Bank. A better way to bank. Member FDIC. Visit us online at clarionbank.com.
All right, back at Memorial Stadium. Mike Kalinowski, the governor, Bob Dunkel with you. Third quarter action coming up. Third quarter brought to you by Zockrell Motors here on the Explorer Radio Network. Make sure you stay tuned afterwards, too, as the Advanced Disposal Explore Clarion Overtime Scoreboard Show. And Chris Dustin back in the studios. We'll have all kinds of guests all over District 9, and I know they'll have folks from this game as well at this Black and Blue Brawl.
Yeah, you know, if you want to find out what's going on throughout District 9, you want to do it one-stop shopping, if you will. You can do that tonight immediately following this broadcast.
The Bobcats will get the ball to start the third quarter as they elected. They got the coin toss to start the game, but deferred. The Lions did drive and score in that opening possession, but that's been all from the Lions so far here this evening. They did have a deep drive late there in the second half, but they could not get the ball in the end zone. And here's the kick. Seifert sends it deep. And taking it at about the 12, to the 15, to the 20, to the 25-yard line, up near the 30, to the 35, to the 40, 45, 50. And across midfield, that carrying the football for the Bobcats, that was Zerfoss, taking the ball all the way down to the Lion 39-yard line.
Well, I tell you, it looked like he was going to hit pay dirt there. Michael had a nice seam, but a good tackle to bring him down. But outstanding field position once again here for the Bobcats. They set up shop at the 40-yard line, the nose of the football just touching the line, 40-yard line here.
Yeah, they were ahead there at the 39, but backed it up to the 40. They said that's where the knee went down, and here we go. The Bobcats with the football. They lead by 20. Wide out to the right, that's a Burford. Backs are going to line up in the I formation. They're going to have Miller under center. In motion goes the man right to left, and they're going to hand the football off, and that's Rapp getting the carry right up the gut, keeps the legs going, and he'll take it up, picking up about 3 yards on the play. Gets near the 37-yard line, second down here in 7.
Yeah, Rapp, I talked about it several times. Very hard-nosed runner, but also he's got that breakaway speed to run to the outside. That's what you keep, really keeps you guessing, keeps you on your heels if you're on that line defense, because you know he's going to get the football. But where is he going to get it? Where is he going to take it to?
Second down and 7. Ball resting at the 37-yard line of the Lions after the big return by Zerfoss. Miller's under center. In motion, man-to-man, left to right, but a flag on the play. They're going to back this one up 5 yards.
Now, it's actually going to be against the Lions. It should be encroachment here as they broke the play.
Okay, yep, you did. I thought on that right side I saw a little bit of movement, but you're right. Offsides against the Lions here. They'll move it ahead 5 yards and sets up a second and 2.
That time, Michael, the defense was going to be blitzing and just mistimed it by about a half a second.
Second down and 2 here for the Bobcats as the ball now rests at the 32 after the penalty to the Lions. Miller pitches it back, carrying the football to the left side. And a first down carry at about the 20-yard line. Rapp getting the carry that time, and he's going to take that football down to about the 19. So a big carry for him, puts it in the M&B Ready Mix red zone.
It'll give him 149 yards of the ball game.
And a first down for the Bobcats at the line, 19-yard line.
Well, I'm going to tell you, I'm sure everybody on that line defense was well aware who Colton Rapp was, and I think most of District 9 knows, but if you don't, you should be aware of that name because he is a very, very physical guy back there in that backfield.
McCloskey back there, this time with Miller, who works out of the shotgun. They're going to come to the left side. Miller's looking for a blocker, and he doesn't have one there. But he does surge forward. We'll get positive yardage over that left side. He's going to take that football down to about the 16-yard line. So a pickup of about three for Miller that time. Good job for him. Second down, seven here for the Bobcats as they look to build on the 28-8 lead on the Lions.
Yeah, this is why I love an offense like this, because they're just eating time off the clock. We're down already to 10:05 here remaining in quarter number three. They took this opening kickoff just methodically of taking care of business.
Miller under center. Lions almost jump and get back. Takes the snap, hands the football off. That's a wrap, and he's hitting the backfield, and he's dropped. A loss on the play back near the 18-yard line, maybe the 19. We'll see where they spot the football.
Well, if you remember early on this drive, the line defense tried to time the count. They didn't and committed the encroachment violation. That time they did time the count. And almost a full 10 yards. It's officially third and nine, but it may as well be third and nine and three quarters, if you will, to pick up that first down. 9:23 on the clock.
Burford the wide out to the right. In the slot on that right side, that's McMaster. Backs around the quarterback as Miller rolls to the right side. Miller looking to throw. Fires toward the end zone or down toward the 5-yard line. It's caught down there. The pass is caught inside the five. It'll be a first and goal, and Burford got the catch. And that'll drop the markers, and it's a first and goal for the Bobcats from the three.
Yeah, I was wondering whenever they were going to go to Burford. That time they waste very little time here. And quarter number three, they hit him. And brings up that first and goal situation. This wide side of the field here now to the left. I think you got to dial up either Miller, Rapper, McCloskey, one of the big three in this situation. They're bringing everybody in tight.
It's at the 2-yard line officially. They're going to hand the football off, and I think that's McCloskey getting the push, and he's going to get that football down to the goal line and then into the end zone for the touchdown. Another touchdown for McCloskey.
McCloskey, that's money in the bank, that guy. What a performance out of him tonight.
So 9 minutes to go here in this third quarter, and the McCloskey with his fifth touchdown of the night. That one goes for 2 yards.
You think he's vying for that Hager paving player of the ball game?
You crazy. And we'll see what the Bobcats decide to do here. They're going to go for the two-point conversion. Right now it's 34-8. And Miller spins, rolls to the left side, looking for the end zone. And that pass is picked off. The pass is picked off, so the two-point conversion is no good. And that makes it 34-8 in favor of the Bobcats. We'll take a timeout. 9 minutes to go here in the third quarter. And the Bobcats in control, 34-8. We'll pause about 30 seconds. Back with more after this on the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse and exploreClarion.com.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community's need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins Road in Clarion. Call us toll-free at 1-800-262-2118.
Attention all car buyers. The biggest year-end Clear the Lot blowout is happening this month at Clarion Ford. All 2016s must go, and Clarion Ford will give you your best deal along with 0% up to 72 months financing during the Ford Freedom Sales event. And find fantastic year-end prices on all 2016 Ford F-150s, America's best-selling truck for 39 years. And get 0% for 72 months or over $5,000 in factory rebates and bonus cash. Remember, nobody beats a Clarion Ford deal. Nobody. Clarion Ford, East Main Street.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
Did you know the average in-state public college is $20,800 per year and a private school averages over $45,000? Are you prepared to help your child or grandchild go to college? There are many savings options and tax incentives for you to consider. We can help you create a college savings plan. Visit JannieClarion.com to learn more or call us at 223-9990. Jannie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist: savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs, located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
Here's the kickoff, and it is taken at about the 15 to the 20, and coming back with the football. Is that, make sure we get the right one. That's Carly on the return, and he's hit and gets up slowly, but he's all right as he'll go off the football field. So the Lions have the football and at their own 23-yard line. They trail here 34-8.
Well, this really, you know, puts yourself behind the eight ball if you own a situation. It's time for you almost got to get a lock game fire here. Takes you out of your normal game plan.
Lions with the football. They trail here in the ball game. Quick swing pass to the left side, and it's dropped out there by Callen, and it's going to roll out of bounds. It was a forward pass. It falls incomplete.
But that was a smart move on the part of Callen. He attempted to cover that up because you don't want to take the chance and not cover that.
Second down and 10 here for the Lions. Of course, stay tuned after the broadcast. Down on the football field, Bob will be handing out the Black and Blue Brawl trophy, the first one in this series. McCray steps up into the pocket, looks to throw, fires downfield. He's got his receiver. That's Ledbetter with the catch. Gets out of a tackle, stays on his feet somehow. Here's Ledbetter back up near the 38-yard line, and finally it takes a host of tacklers to get him down. That's a first down for the Lions, and Ledbetter's going to pick up about 15 on that one as it's out near the 38-yard line.
Yeah, reminded me almost of a punching bag there. They were clean shots, but he just kept on going and finally goes down after about seven or eight different Bobcats make contact with him, but end result's the first down. That's shot in the arm this offense was looking for.
Lions back up to the line of scrimmage, the ball at their own 38-yard line. Ball snap back, and it's going to be picked up by McAfee, and he's just going to be bowled over. That was a ugly play from beginning to end. The ball is snapped back, and I don't think McCray was ready.
Yeah, there was confusion. Anytime you see that many players kind of look like, wait a minute, it looks like the timing was off, and actually I think they sort of thought the play might even be stopped because of a procedure call, and the officials let it go.
So that'll push it all the way back to the 30-yard line. Sets up a second down here and 18.
And they get the play in here from the sideline. 7:45 here. Plenty of time on the down clock, down to 10 seconds.
Third quarter again brought to you by Zockrell Motors. McCray out of the shotgun. He'll send Ledbetter in motion right to left. They're going to give that ball to Ledbetter. Here's Ledbetter over the left side, tries to turn the corner. Ledbetter, 35. Ledbetter back up near the original line of scrimmage, maybe about a yard shy of it. They'll put him at the 37, but it will set up a third down here and still long at 11 yards.
And certainly positive yards are the key here each and every play, a third and 11. You're almost thinking here it's to the point in the ballgame where if you don't pick up that first down, you may seriously contemplate going forward on fourth.
Ball snap back to McCray, comes to the right side. He's going to run with the football. He's McCray, and he's hit. He's hit very hard, and he's only going to get 2 yards, maybe, nope, just a yard. Back up to the 38, so fourth down and 10. And the Lions, and we have another injured player down on the football field. And while they do that, we'll take a quick break here. 34-8, it's fourth and 10 for the Lions. Injured player on the field, and we'll pause 30 seconds. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Roadhouse, right here on exploreClarion.com.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value. Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist. Savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs. Located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
Are you planning a party? Why not a pool party? Give them a party they will never forget at the Park Inn by Radisson. Right now, they are taking reservations for pool parties. You can book your party for any Sunday from 2 to 4 or from 5 to 7. Up to 25 people can attend. You can bring your own food, beverage, and cake. Who wouldn't want a poolside party? So throw a party with style at the Park Inn by Radisson. Just call 226-8850 to book your party today.
Looking for an apartment? Let Corsetti Rentals provide you with your housing needs. Come check out our townhouse rentals near Marianna Estates and on the east end of Clarion near Sheets and Clarion Ford. With student and non-student rentals located throughout the Clarion area, some within sight of Clarion University, and semester leases available too. Call Ron Corsetti Rentals at 226-8262, that's 226-8262, to schedule a showing.
Hey y'all, it's Lori from Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. RCBS reloading supplies are the best. We carry Chargemaster combos, powder tricklers, hand priming tools, electronic and manual scales. Get the best RCBS reloading supplies at Route 66 Sporting Goods. Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. Located on Route 66, just north of Clarion, open 7 days a week. Call 814-226-4055 or visit us online at Route66SportingGoods.com.
Hi, this is Amy with S&W Auto Body in Lucinda. For over 25 years now, we have been providing auto body repair services for deer damage, collision, or your dings, dents, and scratches. We also install windshields, do general maintenance including oil changes, brakes, and state inspections. And for those of you who aren't car savvy, don't worry. Give us a call or stop in and we will talk you through your car issues to find the problem. S&W Auto Service Center, located on Shill Lane in Lucinda, where strangers are treated like friends and friends like family. 226-7046.
The injured player was wrapped. He does come off the field under his own power, which is great to see. And back to action we're going to go here on fourth down and 10. The Lions with the football, but they are going to have to punt.
Remember, the last punt attempt was blocked or partially blocked.
McMaster back to take it. Hummel to punt. And he shanks it off the side of his foot. It's going to bounce and roll out of bounds at the Clarion 49-yard line. So great field position here for the Bobcats. As they will take over, they lead 34-8 with 6:55 to go here in quarter number three.
Well, you know, one of the things in a ball game like this, Michael, is when you're an offense, you want to score early, often continue to do so, and certainly that's what the Bobcats want to do here. It is a comfortable lead, but they still want to get some more points on the board.
Ball's at the 49-yard line of the Bobcats as they eye midfield here. Great field position after the punt. Miller's under center. McCloskey in the backfield will send the man in motion. They're going to pitch that ball. And I think that's, is that Rapp back in there? Yep, Rapp got the carry that time. He did leave earlier, but he's right back in there. Gets a good carry, and he'll take it up near midfield. He'll step out of bounds. It's only about a yard. Second down and 9.
And again, of course, the clock will stop in that situation as he goes out of bounds. But love this offense. This is a, you know, we talk about all the time a two-minute offense. This is what you call a four-minute offense. Doesn't necessarily have to score, but it can burn 4 minutes almost any time it touches the football.
Ball resting at midfield here for the Bobcats. Second down and 9. Miller's under center again. They're going to send Rapp in that sweep motion, but they're going to give it to McCloskey, though, and he busts through the middle, 40, 35, to the 30, and he's finally a shoestring tackle. We'll get him, and they'll knock him down at the 30-yard line. About 20 yards on that run for McCloskey as he went from midfield down to the 30.
Yep, and more importantly, for this Bobcat squad, it moves the chains. They get the chains set up. They get the clock rolling. 6:40 to go here, quarter number 3. And you can see this is what a good running game will do. It just tends to wear that defense down. And an awful lot of pounding takes place.
Well, here we go. Ball to 30-yard line. First and 10 for the Bobcats. The ball pitch back. Here's Rapp with the carry. Rapp gets out of a tackle down to the 20-yard line and finally brought down. Out of bounds on the near side of the football field, but not before he gets a first down. He'll pick up 11, and that's a Bobcat first down in the M&B Ready Mix red zone at the 19-yard line.
Yeah, give him 158 on the night now, 14 different touches out of Rapp. And again, Mike, you brought it up, moves those chains.
Of course, tonight we have the Black and Blue Brawl trophy. But also tonight as well, Coach Weiser, if this score stands, right now 34-8, will pick up win number 200, a big milestone in his career. And the Bobcats driving again with the ball sitting at the 19 of the Lions. Out of the shotgun, Miller rolls to the right side. Miller steps up into the pocket now, looks to throw toward the end zone. It's a fight for the ball, and it's going to be intercepted down in the end zone. The ball is picked off in the end zone, and the Lions will bring it back out. So Ledbetter down in the end zone with the interception. It was a jump ball, but Ledbetter went up and got it.
Yeah, Ledbetter that time goes up top, prevents the score. Time only really one deep receiver to go to. That was the only option. And Ledbetter there in the coverage, made the read, got a nice vertical. So 6:08, Lions will set up shop here at the 20-yard line.
Lions with the football now. McCray swing pass to the right side. Gets that to his intended receiver. That is Ledbetter, and he will get it. But not anything as far as yardage goes. He'll just get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's all good coverage on that outside by the Bobcats. Second down and 10 here for the Lions.
And you can see, Mike, in this situation that Now the Bobcats are the ones applying the pressure. It's a four-man front, which has done a great job. They have controlled the line of scrimmage tonight. So now the linebacking corps says, hey, we want a little part of that.
Whistles blow. Do we have a timeout? And there is a timeout. So we'll take a timeout here, and as they will clear the field. We're going to keep it right here for a second.
Not sure exactly
there's
what
something
the
else.
Everybody, please clear the walking area between the fence and the grandstand. We have an ambulance coming through there.
There had been some extracurricular activities that took place, and not sure exactly what all did take place, so I won't speculate on that, but they need to bring in the ambulance to take a look.
So they are going to clear this. So while they do that, we're going to take a break. We'll pause a couple minutes while they get the ambulance in here. They're going to stop the play on the football field, and the Bobcats lead at 34-8 at this point, and we will take that timeout right now. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Roadhouse, right here on exploreclarion.com.
Look no further than the Loomis for great food, drinks, and service. Featuring certified Angus steaks, classic pastas, hometown favorites, and of course, our incredible Loomis pizza. Free delivery to businesses during lunch. The Loomis Bar features pizza and wing specials and live music Saturday nights. Let us host your next event at the Loomis in one of our spacious banquet facilities. The Loomis. Like the Loomis on Facebook for daily specials and events, or call 226-
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist, savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Our roots are right here in this area. We're local. Many of us were born and raised in the hometowns that we serve. Some places have local branches. We have local roots. First United National Bank, the Fun Bank, member FDIC. Online at fun-bank.com.
It's the kind of pride that you feel inside. We've got the hometown spirit.
The Cooper Tire Take the Money and Ride event is back this fall. Whether you're ready to tailgate or take a scenic drive, you can get the right tires and a reward of up to $70 with the purchase of a new set of four qualifying tires through October 31st. It's the perfect way to get your car ready for the season and score up to a $70 prepaid card by mail when you purchase a new set of four all-terrain Discover AT3s, pavement-gripping Cooper Xeon RS3 G1s, or other qualifying Cooper tires. Carling Tire, the area's largest selection of tires.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
He's on the 30, he's on the 20, he's on the 10, it's a touchdown!
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools.
Clarion County Community Bank, a better way to bank. Member FDIC. Visit us online at clarionbank.com.
Right now at Memorial Stadium, we're awaiting an ambulance to come to attend to an injured person from the crowd. So we're going to continue with our commercials. We'll get our commercials in, and we'll continue to break back in. We'll let you know what's going on. The emergency personnel is here at this point. Both of the teams are off the field, and we'll be back here in just a few moments as we continue here from Memorial Stadium in Clarion.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community's need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins Road in Clarion. Call us toll free at 1-800-262-2118.
Attention all car buyers. The biggest year-end clear the lot blowout is happening this month at Clarion Ford. All 2016s must go, and Clarion Ford will give you your best deal along with 0% up to 72 months financing during the Ford Freedom Sales event. And find fantastic year-end prices on all 2016 Ford F-150s, America's best-selling truck for 39 years. And get 0% for 72 months or over $5,000 in factory rebates and bonus cash. Remember, nobody beats a Clarion Ford deal. Nobody. Clarion Ford, East Main Street.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
Did you know the average in-state public college is $20,800 per year and a private school averages over $45,000? Are you prepared to help your child or grandchild go to college? There are many savings options and tax incentives for you to consider. We can help you create a college savings plan. Visit JannieClarion.com to learn more or call us at 223-9990. Jannie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist, savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs. Located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
All right, back at Memorial Stadium, we are in a medical emergency where a person had fallen out of the stands. They do have them on a board, and I do believe they said that we are going to be bringing in a life flight helicopter here to the stadium, so we are going to be in a medical emergency here. Bob, have you heard anything else from your standpoint?
No, of course, the texts are coming in fast and furious, and being quite honest, we absolutely do not know. So any news, certainly we'll keep you in the loop. We'll let you know. Meantime, what we will do is this has given us an opportunity here. We'll take a look at that Zarco Motors scoreboard. So as we look there, it is Carson City up 40-0 over Punxsie. It is Red Bank Valley 21, Brookville 0. It is St. Mary's 25, Union AC Valley 6, that in quarter number 3. Monetaz 16, Keystone 6. And Clearfield cruising against Central Mountain mid-fourth quarter. They're up 21-7. As we take a look to the north, it is Dubois 35, Warren 14. We just did get some good news, by the way. They will not be bringing in the medevac helicopter to the scene, so that is good news. The players right now are back out on the field, have returned. They are stretching, and we'll have a couple of minutes, I'm sure, put on the game clock for players to get loose again. Brockway 17, Ridgeway 10, that in quarter number 3. Kane 16, Kerwinsville 6. That would have been a fun game to be at as well, mm-hmm. Michael. Two very physical teams doing battle in that ball game. So we take a look at the AML North. It is Otto Elder 37, Port Allegheny 0, Countersport 22, Sheffield 13, and Smithport 6, Cameron County 0, that in the third quarter as well. So the good news is, of course, the medical personnel taking care of business here. No idea who it was, no idea young or old, but ultimately certainly receiving great care as everybody responding immediately to the situation. Of course, you know, our eyes certainly were not on it and did not see any activity take place. So this is where we sit here as we are in quarter number 3. It is a 34-8 lead out of this Bobcat squad.
And they are finishing up their warm-ups on the football field. We'll be getting back to football here momentarily. And again, you do want to stay tuned, folks, tonight. A lot coming your way here on the postgame show as we will have the Advanced Disposal Friday night overtime show as Chris and Dustin back in the studios will have all the scores for you from all over District 9. You want to stay tuned for that. But here we will have the presentation of the Black and Blue Brawl trophy. It's brand new. If you look at the website, I know they have pictures up of that trophy. It's very, very nice. And that trophy has room for the next 25 years to put the scores on there. So tonight, Bob, you have the honor as the oldest for high school football. And you get to go down there and present that trophy. You going to say anything to anybody? What are you going to do?
I'm going to say congratulations is what I'm going to say because, of course, I consider myself very fortunate to be part of this night and certainly even more fortunate to pass that trophy.
So we are in quarter number 3, folks. Still 5:36 to go on the clock. The Lions have the football. It is a second down and 10 from their own 20-yard line. 34-8 is our score as the Bobcats lead. McCray will look to throw. Here's McCray, has protection. McCray fires the football down the left side. Coming back for the ball was the receiver, and the flag comes in. The receiver could not get back to the ball, and that'll be a pass interference. And the Lions will get a first down out of this one.
Yeah, that time, you know, wasn't a whole lot of doubt on that one as Sterling Connor was in coverage. On the defense. That's a and that's not necessarily, and a lot of times people get excited about that. It's not necessarily a bad thing to commit a foul like that.
No.
Look, it's a lot better to give up 15 than 50 yards.
Absolutely. So the ball placed up at the 35-yard line.
Lions quickly in and out of the huddle. We are 5:29 on the clock.
Twins on each side for McCray out of the shotgun. The ball snapped back to him. They'll give it to McAfee, who's got a bit of a hole up the middle. He's to the 40. Here's McAfee, 45. First down. Out to the 48-yard line goes McAfee. They'll say the knee's down. At about the 47-yard line. And that's a gain of 12 for him and a first down here for the Lions.
Great example of calling the right play, right time. That time pressure coming from the linebacker spot. It was Rapp applying the pressure. And that opened up a gap, and that was exactly where the play was called. Doesn't always work that way. That time, a break for the Lions.
Ball at the 47 for the Lions on their own side of the football field. Now the pocket collapses. McCray rolls to the right side, pumps once. He's going to run. Here's McCray. Now fires. He was past the line of scrimmage. This will not count. He did get the pass completed, but this is going to come back. The flags are flown or thrown. He threw the ball at about the 49-yard line of Clarion, but the was well past the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, no question about that one as it's going to come back that time. What happened there was McCray was under pressure. He was rolling and lost because he had to back up so far because that pressure was coming at him. He lost presence of mind exactly where he was at on the football field, and he did have positive yards made, but he was a good 3 or 4 yards past the line of scrimmage, yep. And the official's right on top of it.
Yeah, if he would have tucked the football, probably would have ended up with a decent gain, but as you said, kind of lost where he was at.
Yeah, it would have been very close because, you know, keep in mind he's running on the opposite side of where those down markers are.
On the offense, personal foul on the defense, penalties offset, replay the down.
And we did not see that personal foul take place on the defensive side. It was certainly away from most of the action, and the officials doing a great job that time. This is where it's fabulous to have a mic. We're fortunate to be here and have the opportunity where we get to hear the official give the explanation over the PA system.
So we do the old-fashioned do-over. That's when you couldn't agree with your friends.
Seems like a long time ago.
No, you still don't agree with me.
Oh, yeah, that's par for the course.
McAfee with a run right up the gut. Big hole, 50, 45, 40 to the 35, and he's tripped up to the 30-yard line. Boy, and I'll tell you what, if it was not for Sterling Connor, McAfee's in the end zone, that shoestring tackle, and the Lions with the football down at the Bobcat 30-yard line.
And moves the chains. The clock will start as soon as the chains are put in place. It does. We're at 440 here, quarter number three. It's a 34-8 ball game.
And that actually would have been a loss of down and a penalty, but instead, because of the personal foul, the Lions now with a big gain and a first down at the 30. Here's McCray to the right side. McCray, lots of time. Now tucks the football, pumps once, he's hit, and McCray's going to be sacked. Good coverage downfield. He had nowhere to go, and he'll be dropped for a yard loss back to the 31-yard line.
Definition of a coverage sack that time. Outstanding coverage. The difference between this week and last week, the defenders back there, Michael, were keeping every receiver in front of them in that time in great position to make a play. And there simply was nothing for McCray there. The only option he might have had would be to run, and he's only going to pick up maybe a yard or so at best on that.
He'll break the huddle, come to the line. Actually, they're going to say no gain on the play. The ball's resting at the 30-yard line. It's a second and 10. The Lions at the Bobcat 30. Here's a handoff. McAfee over the left side. And the ball came out. And the Lions are able to get on top of it. McAfee went to the left side, but the ball squirted back. And that'll be a loss on the play of five back to the 35-yard line. And it's a third now and 15.
That time the blitz forces that fumble. And these linebackers, Mike, between McCloskey and Rapp, those guys both licking their chops. It looks like a dog at a butcher shop almost the way they're going at it.
They are going to land a helicopter here. They're
going to charge him $8,000 to ride that. So 3:03 on the clock. Lions will take their time here. They're down to 12 as they break the huddle on the play clock.
They'll split twins on each side. Here's McCray out of the shotgun on 3rd and 15. Pocket collapses, rolls to the left side, spinning around, fires the football, and very wisely just gets rid of it. You know, that was one thing I remember talking to Malin Luke years and years ago, and he made a comment in one of our shows where he said, you know, sometimes the best decision my quarterback can make is just to throw that ball away, and you saw McCray do it that time.
You know, I say basically the same thing. Sometimes the best pass you throw is an incomplete one because nothing but bad things were going to happen that time as McCray is running for his life back there. He's under all kinds of pressure. Not a receiver open again, and he threw it and actually had a receiver in the area. There wasn't any chance he was going to be able to catch it unless he became 10, 12 foot tall. But, you know, certainly a wise move living here for another down. It's a 4th and 15 situation.
So a big fourth down here for the Lions as they try to claw back in the game. They try to get the screen set up. They do to the right side. That's McAfee. He's to the 30, and a flag comes in.
Well, I think the penalty will be declined. It will be a hold in the offensive line. End result, they'll take the result of the play, and it'll be well short of the first down, so it should become Bobcat football.
Yeah, he's only going to pick up about four, maybe five on the play. And it's going to come back, or it will be right there at the 30, so it'll be first down here for the Bobcats. As they decline it, they'll take over on downs. They're going to place the ball to 28-yard line of Clarion area. We're at quarter number three. Again, the third quarter brought to you by Zockrell Motors, down to 2:38 to go. It's 34-8 Bobcats.
And we have our first slight breeze of the evening.
Feels pretty good.
Did you just drink a cup of coffee?
That
you're
nice,
watching
it,
that
nice
deep sigh.
Fresh breeze there.
It is fall, you know.
Absolutely. Handoff here. Rapp getting the carry. Gets up near the 30, maybe the 31-yard line. So give him about three on the play. Sets up a second down here at 7.
Yeah, Rapp now up to 161. As Miller gets the instructions from the sideline. And you'll see here, again, this they're trying to have that four-minute offense take place. Just want to milk some time. They do have a comfortable lead here. You're not going to see him try anything crazy at this point.
Miller's under center. Hands it off again. Wrap right up the gut. And he'll be dropped short gain. Gets up near the 33. Just give him about a yard, maybe two on the play. And it looks like still about a third down and 5. As the ball rests at the Clarion 33-yard line and the clock continues to move, as Bob said.
Yeah, I don't think, again, you won't see much here. I think the odds are Spencer Miller's probably going to keep this football and have the option either to tuck it, run, or throw it. Of course, they've had success with sweeps as well.
Yeah, they run Rapp from that left side. They're going to do that again as they'll sweep him. They're going to pitch it to Rapp, and he tries to turn the corner, and Rapp turns upfield, and Rapp's got the – well, he's close to the first down marker. I think he's going to have it – well, no, I think he may be short. He had to get
– should be short by about a half a yard.
Yeah, he had to get to the 38, and he's going to get to about the 37.5. So it's a fourth down and short.
And there may be at least a measurement. It looks like the officials are going to come in together now. I think we will see a measurement on this. I thought initially it would be a half yard short, but it is a whole lot closer now with that spot of the football.
So they'll bring on the chains here. Late here in quarter number 3. Boy, glad you could be along tonight here in this black and blue brawl.
Mike, it is the first down.
And they're going to move the chains.
It did not look like he had initially made the yards, but again, the officials brought the chains out, and they say, we stand corrected. Move that chain. So we take a look at some of the other scores here. Throughout District 9, Red Bank Valley up 21-0 over Brookville. Union is trailing 25-14. St. Mary's again up 25-14 over Union AC Valley. Monotop 30, Keystone 6.
Miller keeps it, comes to the left side. Had a blocker, McCloskey, but then it closes up quickly. The ball's out. And who's going to have the football here? I believe the Bobcats, were they able to get back? Or they're going to say he's down. They're going to say he is down as McAfee came up with the football.
And then a late call saying, no, it is the line ball now.
Wow. We've had a lot of these late calls this evening, but
well, what the officials are trying to do is get the correct call. So they're taking their time and getting the correct call.
Okay.
Sometimes it's not a popular way of doing things, but look, you know, I think we'd all be in agreement. You want to take your time and get the correct call out there.
It's an instant society, though. We want it now.
Well, you know, you being a guy in stripes, why?
Yeah.
I thought you might want to go to bat for those guys once in a while.
I just like it a little quicker. Ball at the 36-yard line. First and 10 for the Lions. They do get the turnover. Here's a handoff. McAfee tries to turn over the left side, and we'll get to a about the 35-yard line, ekes out about a yard is all. They may move it down closer to the 34. Give them two officially, second down here in about 8. And that's the last play of quarter number 3. We'll switch sides. Quarter number 4 is on the way. It is 34-8, the Bobcats leading the Lions. And you're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, and it's right here on exploreclarion.com.
Are you planning a party? Why not a pool party? Give them a party they will never forget at the Park Inn by Radisson. Right now, they are taking reservations for pool parties. You can book your party for any Sunday from 2 to 4 or from 5 to 7. Up to 25 people can attend. You can bring your own food, beverage, and cake. Who wouldn't want a poolside party? So throw a party with style at the Park Inn by Radisson. Just call 226-8850 to book your party today.
Looking for an apartment? Let Corsetti Rentals provide you with your housing needs. Come check out our townhouse rentals near Marianna States and on the east end of Clarion near Sheets and Clarion Ford. With student and non-student rentals located throughout the Clarion area, some within sight of Clarion University, and semester leases available too. Call Ron Corsetti Rentals at 226-8262. That's 226-8262 to schedule a showing.
Hey y'all, it's Lori from Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. RCBS reloading supplies are the best. We carry Charge Master combos, powder tricklers, hand priming tools, electronic and manual scales. Get the best RCBS reloading supplies at Route 66 Sporting Goods. Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. Located on Route 66, just north of Clarion, open 7 days a week. Call 814-226-4055 or visit us online at Route66SportingGoods.com.
Hi, this is Amy with S&W Auto Body in Lucinda. For over 25 years now, we have been providing auto body repair services for deer damage, collision, or your dings, dents, and scratches. We also install windshields, do general maintenance including oil changes, brakes, and state inspections. And for those of you who aren't car savvy, don't worry. Give us a call or stop in and we will talk you through your car issues to find the problem. S&W Auto Service Center, located on Shill Lane in Lucinda, where strangers are treated like friends and friends like family. 226-7046.
Look no further than the Loomis for great food, drinks, and service. Featuring certified Angus steaks, classic pastas, hometown favorites, and of course, our incredible Loomis pizza. Free delivery to businesses during lunch. The Loomis Bar features pizza and wing specials and live music Saturday nights. Let us host your next event at the Loomis in one of our spacious banquet facilities. The Loomis. Like the Loomis on Facebook for daily specials and events or call 226-
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist, savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
All right, back at Memorial Stadium. Mike Halinowski, then the Governor Bob Dunkel right here for you. As we get set for quarter number four, and quarter number four is brought to you by Clarion County Community Bank. Clarion County Community Bank, our fourth quarter sponsor. Great to have them on board with us.
Yeah, this is one of those deals. Must get points out of this drive as there's only 12 minutes remaining in this ball game. You trail 34-8.
McCray comes under center, backs in the I formation. He's going to fake the handoff, rolls to the right side, looks to throw, and it's batted down. At that line of scrimmage, was that Worcester again?
Yes.
Boy, he's been, that's what, his third or fourth of the ball game.
Yep, he's got those long arms, does an outstanding job, bats it down. You know, that time McCray had the good blocking set up in front of him. He's able to roll around, but Worcester gets those arms extended. And again, sometimes all you've got to do, you just got to create a little bit of traffic. And he's created traffic already. He's wound up blocking three passes tonight.
Third down and eight here for the Lions as they try to get something moving. They trail, as we said, and they have the ball at the 34-yard line of the Bobcats. After the turnover, McCray will roll to the right side. McCray steps up. He's grabbed. He's dropped. He's sacked on the play. And guess who again? That's Tom Worcester getting the sack as he knocks him down back at the 42-yard line, Bob.
That, my friend, is all about arm strength that time because that's what that was. That was an arm tackle as he's able to extend those big long arms out. And it's a loss of 6 yards on that. You probably were hoping to see the tear-free jerseys those days because that jersey would have tore-free, trust me.
Fourth.
Now we've dated our age because, absolutely, of course, that was like circa, what, 82, 83, something like that.
Fourth down and 16. Ball rests down at the Bobcat 42-yard line. The Lions will come up here on this fourth down. Try to keep this drive going as they trail here 34-8. Low snap to McCray. Has protection. Fires down the middle of the field. There it is. Caught! and that is Hummel, and Hummel's going to go into the end zone for the Lion touchdown. That will cover 42 yards and a touchdown.
What a beautiful catch and run that time. The time was on the money. Hummel was hit in full stride, and he goes in on a crucial fourth down play.
And that comes at the 10:56 mark here in this fourth quarter. And they're going to go for the two-point conversion here, as they will come up to the line of scrimmage. Do the Lions. They'll put Ledbetter wide out to the right. Trip backs in the backfield behind the quarterback. And McCray rolls to the right side and goes down on one knee as he trips up. And the two-point conversion is no good, but that will make it 34-14 in favor of the Bobcats as they continue to lead here in this one. And we'll take another timeout. Folks, you're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, and it's right here on exploreclarion.com.
Hometown spirit, nothing else comes near it.
Our roots are right here in this area. We're local. Many of us were born and raised in the hometowns that we serve. Some places have local branches. We have local roots. First United National Bank, the Fun Bank, member FDIC. Online at fun-bank.com.
It's the kind of pride that you feel inside. We've got the hometown spirit.
The Cooper Tire Take the Money and Ride event is back this fall. Whether you're ready to tailgate or take a scenic drive, you can get the right tires and a reward of up to $70 with the purchase of a new set of four qualifying tires through October 31st. It's the perfect way to get your car ready for the season and score up to a $70 prepaid card by mail when you purchase a new set of four all-terrain Discover AT3s, pavement-gripping Cooper Xeon RS3 G1s, or other qualifying Cooper tires. Carling Tire, the area's largest selection of tires.
He's on the 30, he's on the 20, he's on the 10, it's a touchdown!
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools.
Clarion County Community Bank, a better way to bank. Member FDIC. Visit us online at clarionbank.com.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
All right, back here at Memorial Stadium, the Lions scoring the 42-yard touchdown from McCray to Hummel. Mike Kalinowski, Governor Bob Dunkel with you here this evening. Great you could be along here on exploreclarion.com.
Always
a squib kick. And that ball's loose. It is a squib kick, but the Bobcats are able to get on top of it. It squirted around a little bit, but Clarion area.
Always enjoy hearing from the fans as they send me text once in a while. 10:53 here. And again, you want to see the 4-minute offense if you're a Bobcat fan here. The onside kick attempt, it was a squib. It comes up empty. The front guys took care of business there. We haven't talked about it much. Didn't want to apply a jinx or anything. Larry Weiser looking to get win number 200. He's been around a long time.
Getting closer and closer with every tick of that clock. Miller's under center, backs in the I formation, single receiver off to the left side. They're going to hand the football off. Rapp is hit and dropped in the backfield. Oh, as he met with a wall, and that'll push him back. They'll lose a couple on the play, sets up a second down and 12 back to the 47-yard line.
And that time, again, it's a case of the defense timing the cadence. Got the snap count correct. You know, Mike, barring anything crazy happening, obviously Coach Weiser will get number 200 this year, tonight certainly, more likely, as we're at the 10:23 mark. But also we've got an opportunity next year long as Itkanto comes back from Cart City, he should, again, depending on how the season finishes out, he should reach that 200-win plateau next year. Of course, that would be the result of the combined AC Valley and Cart City win total.
McMaster, the wideout to the left, Burford to the right. They're going to pitch the ball back to Rapp, though, and Rapp's hit again, and Rapp's dropped again behind the line of scrimmage, back near the 30 or 46-yard line. He'll lose two more, and that's going to set up a third down now. Third down here at about 13.
Clock at 9:43. Third and 13. And again, I think I'd keep it on the ground here. Not so much, you know, the obviously the percentages certainly are against you rushing and picking it up, but let the clock milk down. There's four in the play clock. We'll see a timeout first.
And there will be a timeout on the football field. We'll take a break as well with the Bobcats leading here 34-14. We'll pause. We'll be back with more after this. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, and it's right here on exploreclarion.com.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community's need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins Road in Clarion. Call us toll-free at 1-800-262-2118.
Attention all car buyers. The biggest year-end clear the lot blowout is happening this month at Clarion Ford. All 2016s must go, and Clarion Ford will give you your best deal along with 0% up to 72 months financing during the Ford Freedom Sales event. And find fantastic year-end prices on all 2016 Ford F-150s, America's best-selling truck for 39 years. And get 0% for 72 months or over $5,000 in factory rebates and bonus cash. Remember, nobody beats a Clarion Ford deal. Nobody. Clarion Ford, East Main Street, Clarion.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Stratonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Stratonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
Did you know the average in-state public college is $20,800 per year and a private school averages over $45,000? Are you prepared to help your child or grandchild go to college? There are many savings options and tax incentives for you to consider. We can help you create a college savings plan. Visit JannieClarion.com to learn more or call us at 223-9990. Jannie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist. Savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs, located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
All right, back here. There we go. We were waiting for some music to fire. And back here at Memorial Stadium, It is the Bobcats and the Lions in the Black and Blue Brawl 2016. The award, the trophy, will be given out at the conclusion of the ball game. Bob will be down there to do that.
Putting a lot of pressure on me.
I am. I'm still wondering. You know, you said you're just going to congratulate. You're not going to give words of wisdom or anything. If that was Pat Kale, you're down there telling him all kind of stuff.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, my.
He would have said, when I played for Larry Weiser, this is what happened.
My words of wisdom are, look both ways before you cross the street.
That's good advice. Bobcats with the football, now third down and 13. Miller looks to throw, has great protection, fires down the right sideline, and the pass is going to be incomplete. Tried to find McCloskey as he spun out of the backfield and down the right sideline, but the ball goes out of bounds. So fourth down, we'll see a punt coming up here by the Bobcats. As Miller will be out there punting. And the deep end will be Riley Hummel. Bring up 34-14 our score. The Bobcats in control with 9:15 to go in this one. Game
Lions
was delayed.
Looking to dial up a big return here.
As they show, they're coming after this one, and the punt is away. Miller just got rid of it, but a good kick, too, as it's going to roll inside the 30, inside the 25, and out of bounds. He kind of squibbed it to the right side, but got good leg into it. And that ball comes to rest at the 24-yard line, and that's where the Lions will have it from their own 24, trailing by 20. You were surprised I could add that up, too.
Well, exactly. Not just that. You know, sometimes if you can't add, you just throw numbers out there. No one knows any different.
No, and Dustin Kiefer, actually, too. He doesn't either, so I was always worried about that, but we found out.
As we have a Zocro Motors scoreboard update here. First final of the night, it is Carson City 47, Punxsie 0. Red Bank Valley, last score we had there was 21-0 over Brookville. Monotau up 30-6 over Keystone.
McAfee getting the carry right up the middle, pound banging off of tacklers, and he'll work that football up near the 29-yard line. Give him about five on the play, close to five. Second down here in five from McAfee.
It'll give him 61 the ball game, and we have a Bobcat that looks like he's cramping up a little bit out there.
Yeah, we'll keep it right here for the second, unless they're going to go to the sidelines, and they will. So we'll take a quick timeout. Let's pause 30. Back with more after this. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse right here on exploreClarion.com.
Hey, y'all. It's Lori from Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. RCBS reloading supplies are the best. We carry Charge Master combos, powder tricklers, hand priming tools, electronic and manual scales. Get the best RCBS reloading supplies at Route 66 Sporting Goods. Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. Located on Route 66, just north of Clarion, opens 7 days a week. Call 814-226-4055 or visit us online at Route66SportingGoods.com.
Hi, this is Amy with S&W Auto Body in Lucinda. For over 25 years now, we have been providing auto body repair services for deer damage, collision, or your dings, dents, and scratches. We also install windshields, do general maintenance including oil changes, brakes, and state inspections. And for those of you who aren't car savvy, don't worry. Give us a call or stop in and we will talk you through your car issues to find the problem. S&W Auto Service Center, located on Shill Lane in Lucinda, where strangers are treated like friends and friends like family. 226-7046.
Look no further than the Loomis for great food, drinks, and service. Featuring certified Angus steaks, classic pastas, hometown favorites, and of course, our incredible Loomis pizza. Free delivery to businesses during lunch. The Loomis Bar features pizza and wing specials and live music Saturday nights. Let us host your next event at the Loomis in one of our spacious banquet facilities. The Loomis. Like the Loomis on Facebook for daily specials and events or call 226-
Hi, Dave Kale of Kale's Kitchens in Leaper. Have you ever noticed how some things just stand the test of time? How a balance of function, form, quality materials, and craftsmanship always result in an American product of enduring value? Like great-grandma's Tiffany ring or grandpa's Farmall tractor, or that Duesenberg Model J that always shows up in the local parades. At Kale's Kitchens, we strive to meet those same exacting standards. We endeavor to follow the same proven formula for enduring value and quality with an interesting twist. Savings. Practical savings on the Kale's Kitchen of your dreams. So call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's Kitchens can be. Beginning at $199 a foot, Kale's Kitchens are a timeless American masterpiece that are built to last.
and fulfill a promise of beauty and function at a very appealing price. So for a limited time, call 814-744-9390 or stop by our showroom in Leaper and see how easy and affordable having one of my Kale's kitchens can be. And I'll throw in our 40 years of experience at no extra charge.
Hometown spirit, nothing else comes near it.
Our roots are right here in this area. We're local. Many of us were born and raised in the hometowns that we serve. Some places have local branches. We have local roots. First United National Bank, the Fun Bank, member FDIC. Online at fun-bank.com.
It's the kind of pride that you feel inside. We've got the hometown spirit.
The Cooper Tire Take the Money and Ride event is back this fall. Whether you're ready to tailgate or take a scenic drive, you can get the right tires and a reward of up to $70 with the purchase of a new set of four qualifying tires through October 31st. It's the perfect way to get your car ready for the season and score up to a $70 prepaid card by mail when you purchase a new set of four all-terrain Discover AT3s, pavement-gripping Cooper Xeon RS3 G1s, or other qualifying Cooper tires. Carling Tire, the area's largest selection of tires.
All right, back here at Memorial Stadium. Injury timeout down there. Oh, well, I guess I should turn you up, Bob.
Yeah, well, you know, that comes in handy. I mean, you know, some people, you know, my wife loves to she listens on the game because, you know, that way she can turn me off. She can't do that at home.
She would love this at home. Hook you up to this thing. She could turn you off, not hear you forever.
I'd guarantee I'd be off 95% of the time. What do you think she sentences me to the basement with the two cats?
I was thinking that. That's why you have that close relationship with the cats. They hiss at her. Third or second down here and five. Ball resting at the 29 of the Lions. Here's McCray to the right side. He steps up, looks to throw. He's hit, and he'll be dropped for a loss. He'll just get back near the 28-yard line. That's a loss of one. Sets up a third down and six now for the Lions.
And no huddle offense here for the Lions. Crayon shotgun, he barks out the orders.
Low snap, picks it up. Looks to fire, does. Finds Callen, it's caught. And that is up near the 34. We'll see where the official says he went down and out. It looks like on the near side, he's short on the far side. They said he got it. And it is a fourth down and one. It is a fourth and one from the 33-yard line now for the Lions. They're going to go. Here's McCray now barking the signals, takes the snap, quick drop, throws, fires, caught on the far side. And out there, that's Ledbetter with the catch, and he'll be dropped at about the 41, maybe 42-yard line. Carly, on that far side. It looked like a 9 as he turned, but that's number 15. So Carly gets the catch in the first down. And he takes it out to the 41-yard line. So the Lions get a new set of downs as they convert on that fourth down. McCray now fires across the middle of the field. It's almost intercepted there. And getting his hands on the football and almost bringing it in was Riley McMaster, but it's incomplete.
Yeah, McMaster doing a great job. He's in prime position, bats that away. One of the teammates had a shot at it then on the Tennessee tip drill. So 7:36, the clock will be stopped.
Second down and 10, ball at the 41-yard line of the Lions as they work right to left. Bob appropriately calling it across your computer screen. Hands the football off. McAfee getting the carry right up the gut, and he'll be met by a whole host of tacklers and no gain on the play as he'll just get back to the line of scrimmage. Third down and 10.
We do have an update in that Red Bank Valley game as we look towards that Zocchro Motors scoreboard. It is Red Bank Valley 35, Brookville 0.
Third down and 10, McCray finds Hummel, first down, Hummel 45. Hummel spinning around out of the 41-yard line, and that'll be a first down here for the Lions, and that's a gain of 18.
And Hummel again, that high percentage receiver. See, makes the play.
Lions back to the line of scrimmage from the 41, a handoff to McAfee, and McAfee goes nowhere. He'll be dropped on the play, a couple-yard loss. As he is hit and dropped and getting the tackle that time for the Bobcats was Selker. Looking down here. He's there, but I don't have the right number. Here we go, right back to action. As McCray rolls to the right side, they continue this no-huddle offense. He's hit, and he's dropped for a large loss. back beyond midfield. And they're going to say he's all the way back to the 45-yard line. That's a loss of 14.
You know, once again, credit that defense out there. Those guys remind you of a shark in the ocean as they're just circling the potential victim right now. McCray has faced all kinds of pressure tonight back there. And, again, this defense, four-man front, but Bobcats generally, especially most of this second half, have been applying pressure, have been sending the linebackers a combination of Rapp or McCluskey. Both guys have experienced success back there.
Third down and 24. They'll send twins on each side. McCray fires, finds Hummel on a little slant across the middle, and he'll get it down to the Clarion 45-yard line. They're going to pick up some of that yardage, get back a little bit of the 24, and it sets up a fourth down now and 14, so they pick up about 10. And now McCray back right there with the no-huddle offense out of the shotgun, drops back, looks to throw on fourth down. Fourth and long, fires the ball, and the pass is incomplete. No flags, and the Bobcats will take over at their own 46-yard line. That's where the Bobcats will have it.
Well, this is the most passed attempts we've seen out of any team, Mike, in a couple of years here, as the Lions have attempted 31 passes tonight. Of course, McCray attempting all of them. He's 17 of 31. He does have 207 yards in this one.
So the ball resting at the 46-yard line. The Bobcats with the football and 5:26 to go in this one. Ball resting at the 46. As we said, the ball pitched back, getting the carry. That is a wrap. He's to the 50. Or that's not wrap, but I believe is that.
It was wrap. You can always recognize him. Look at his shoes, yep. The high whites.
Well, similar in style, too, was Zerfaz. But this time, Rapp gets the carry, first down to the 41-yard line.
5:15 now on the clock. It continues to roll. Lions not only have to worry about this attack, but they've got that clock working against them as running out of time here as they trail by 20.
So a new set of downs from the Limestone 41-yard line. The Bobcats, Miller comes under center. He's going to hand the football off. And again over the right side, getting the carry. Rapp again. And he'll be dropped, but good pickup too. He'll pick up about 8 or 9. That's going to get him close down near the 31-yard line. So give him 9 yards, second down and one. Another good run by Rapp.
You know, over the years, Mike, we've talked about Carson City's one of those teams that reloads. Well, the Bobcats almost always seem to have that one running back that is a punishing guy, that's got a lot of speed, that's strong, that's got good ability to make runs out of nothing at times. And, you know, Rapp is one of those guys. Now tonight, he's had plenty of blocking, and he's done a great job. But his speed and overall strength has been very impressive tonight. Clock down to 4:12.
Second down and about two. They're going to hand the football off. Little belly play right up the gut, and it's going to go for the first down inside the 30 and down to the 29-yard line. They only needed a couple, but they'll gain about four. And that was McCloskey getting the carry. McCloskey, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 touchdowns on the day. And we'll have to get that Hager Paving player of the game delivered here in a moment.
He's got 74 yards. And that will move the chains, more importantly. And, again, this is a great example. This is a four-minute offense to talk about. You always hear everybody talk about the two-minute. Well, this is the four-minute. This is what you want. Sometimes people get bored with it, but you talk to any coach, he's going to take this all day. It's a high percentage, low risk offense. Generally, as a rule, lots of good things going to come from it.
We'll stay tight and movement there, and this will come back 5 yards against the Bobcats on the legal procedure.
At the time, McCloskey wanted the extra step. He gets caught with it and put his hands on his hips, knew right away that they were going to catch him. So that will back it up now. Down to 3:36. Mike and I will be arm wrestling very soon to decide who gets the Hager Paving Players of the Game for both sides.
You already filled it out.
That's because I won.
Oh, my goodness. You didn't.
Folks, don't
we didn't
let
even
kid
do
you.
It.
Don't let him kid you, folks. I pinned him in like three seconds.
Mr. Nellis on. He'll tell the truth.
Even though I've got a bad shoulder, I'm still able to pin him in 3 seconds.
Here's the handoff over the right side and running with that football. Again, the Bobcats, as they continue to work the clock off after the penalty, they'll pick up a yard, maybe two is all, and that is Rapp getting the carry that time. Give him a couple. Second down here in 13. The clock down to 3 minutes to go here in this football game. Coming up, of course, it is the First United National Bank, the Fun Bank postgame show. Stats, scoring summary, player of the game, and a whole lot more. Look ahead to next week. A couple games coming your way for the Autumn Leaf Festival, the Autumn Leaf Festival special, Thursday and Friday. You're going to be a busy man next week. Your wife will never see you.
Show me the money.
She'll just be in the corner with the keg on.
She'll be happy about that, too, I think.
Bobcats come up to the line of scrimmage, second down and 13. Miller under center, takes the snap, hands it off again, gives it to Rapp. Rapp, he's going to be hit, wrapped up behind the 35-yard line. That'll be a loss of two, almost three on the play. Sets up a third down now, and looks like about a third down and 16. Clock down to 2:22, and a timeout is being taken on the football field. We'll take a timeout as well. The Bobcats in control, 34-14 over the Lions here in the Black and Blue Brawl 2016. And we'll pause 30 seconds. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, and it's right here on exploreclarion.com.
Hometown spirit, nothing else comes near it.
Our roots are right here in this area. We're local. Many of us were born and raised in the hometowns that we serve. Some places have local branches. We have local roots. First United National Bank, the Fun Bank, member FDIC. Online at fun-bank.com.
It's the kind of pride that you feel inside. We've got the hometown spirit.
The Cooper Tire Take the Money and Ride event is back this fall. Whether you're ready to tailgate or take a scenic drive, you can get the right tires and a reward of up to $70 with the purchase of a new set of four qualifying tires through October 31st. It's the perfect way to get your car ready for the season and score up to a $70 prepaid card by mail when you purchase a new set of four all-terrain Discover AT3s, pavement-gripping Cooper Xeon RS3 G1s, or other qualifying Cooper tires. Carling Tire, the area's largest selection of tires.
He's on the 30, he's on the 20, he's on the 10, it's a touchdown!
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools. Clarion County Community Bank, a better way to bank. Member FDIC. Visit us online at clarionbank.com.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
All right, back here at Memorial Stadium, Clarion University. Mike Kalinowski, the Governor Bob Dunkel with you this evening. And this announcing those Hager Paving, Explore Clarion, players of the game. Bobcats now with the football, and the clock is down to 2:22. It is third down and long. They're going to pitch the ball, and Rapp drops it, picks it back up, and he's going to turn around to the 35, to the 30, stays on his feet, spinning, and gets dropped at about the 26-yard line. Good pickup for him, and it will set up a fourth down now, and about seven, and another timeout being taken on the field. Yes, another timeout is being taken down on the football field. So we got to get some more sponsors in. Why don't we continue to do that? We'll pause another 30 seconds, 34-14. Clarion area in control here late in quarter number four, and it's the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Roadhouse at exploreclarion.com.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community's need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins Road in Clarion. Call us toll-free at 1-800-262-2118.
Attention all car buyers! The biggest year-end clear-the-lot blowout is happening this month at Clarion Ford. All 2016s must go, and Clarion Ford will give you your best deal, along with 0% up to 72 months financing during the Ford Freedom Sales event. And find fantastic year-end prices on all 2016 Ford F-150s, America's best-selling truck for 39 years. And get 0% for 72 months or over $5,000 in factory rebates and bonus cash. Remember, nobody beats a Clarion Ford deal. Nobody. Clarion Ford, East Main Street.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
Did you know the average in-state public college is $20,800 per year and a private school averages over $45,000? Are you prepared to help your child or grandchild go to college? There are many savings options and tax incentives for you to consider. We can help you create a college savings plan. Visit JannieClarion.com to learn more or call us at 223-9990. Jannie Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
Right back here at Memorial Stadium. And a 34-14 lead for the Bobcats of Clarion. Mike Kalinowski, Governor Bob Dunkel.
Now, Mike, I'm going to lean over you because, well, we had to put the glass windows back
all
in
right
here. And it's so just not a pretty sight on my side.
No, we're going to have to do something about those. We'll have to get someone in the know here at Clarion to get these fixed. Here's a quick pitch and a handoff. And a run with the football on fourth down. And it's not going to be enough for the first down. Only really not a whole lot gained at all on fourth and about five. And it'll be turned over to the Lions here on downs. So the Lions will get it back on downs.
And McCluskey that time with the touch. And tough sledding as he's not able to advance it. So with 2:03. It is a Bobcat timeout, so that'll give them one in the game. Michael, do you want to take another timeout?
No, let's keep it here. Of course, coming up here in the postgame show, we'll do the – you'll be heading down for the Black and Blue Brawl trophy, as you will be presenting that trophy, Bob. And then after that, you'll come back up. We'll wrap up this postgame show as we'll have stats. We'll take a look at those Hager Paving players of the game. We'll go through the game replays, and then we'll look ahead to next week, as we said, a couple games on tap. Of course, the Autumn Leaf Festival in town, as the big pageant coming up on Saturday night. I have to attend this year, too. My daughter decided she wanted to be in the Miss Teen ALF pageant. So
I thought you were going to enter.
I tried to talk Greg into doing the Mr. Teen, but he's like, I'm not doing that. Singing. No. But so I'll be up at Mercyhurst tomorrow and then have to fly back for the pageant. But we'll make it happen.
I thought you and your friend Governor Wolf maybe might arrange a flight.
Yeah,
for you.
I don't know if Governor Wolf, if I was nice. I haven't been too nice to him, though. Incomplete pass as McCray tried to fire that football. Incomplete, so second down. Clock stops at 1:59 to go in this one as the Lions are going to the air here with down by 20 with just a couple minutes to go.
You know, right now, it's certainly a pride situation, something to build upon for next week.
Keep an eye on Ben. He keeps taking your tape, too.
Ben can do what he wants because he was a great guy taking out the windows tonight. Really helped
yes,
us out.
Ball snap back to McCray. Looks to throw here on second down. Fires the ball down the left sideline, fighting for the ball, and the ball's incomplete. Threw it into traffic. There were four players down there, two Lions and two Bobcats, but the ball falls incomplete near midfield.
So now 1:52 on the clock. It's a third down situation here. And the crowd a little reserved right now. And again, we are in the cusp, Mike, of being able to congratulate Larry Weiser on win number 200, an amazing accomplishment. Fortunate that we're able to be here to
Absolutely.
Call that one. Called well, an awful lot of those
you,
200
I was going to say, you've been around for all of them. Even though you didn't announce them, you were here. Here's McCray rolling to the right side. He dumps the pass off, and it's going to be picked off. It's intercepted. He fired the ball as he was in the grasp, and the ball is intercepted at the 20-yard line, and now a fight underneath that between the two players on who's going to control the football. And they're going to say the Lions come out with the football. McAfee ripped it away. It was intercepted, but McAfee comes out with the football, so they'll give it to the Lions at the 20. But it's fourth down and 14.
And what they're going to say there is they're going to say both players had possession at the same time, so therefore the offensive player maintains the possession. And the crowd starting a little chant here. Larry, Larry.
Here's a pass across the middle. It is caught by Carly. Here's Carly out to the 25-yard line, but the Bobcats will take over on downs at the Lion 25 after just a 5-yard pickup on that fourth down. So a minute 10, and we're going to see a bunch of knees here, and this ball game's going to be over with. You going to head down, Bob?
I think I should head down here.
All right.
At the 110.
Go ahead before the crowd gets going. I'm going to turn the mic down, and we'll see you here when you come back.
Now, no pressure on you to finish out these stats.
I may wait for you. We'll see. So Bob heading down to the football field as he'll get set for the presentation of the Black and Blue Brawl trophy. Ben coming in here and getting all the windows back in so we don't get in trouble. And a knee taken there by the Bobcats as they will allow that clock now to expire here in the football game. Again, the fourth quarter was brought to you by Clarion County Community Bank, a great sponsor as well here on the EYT Media Network. And the ball now resting at the 25-yard line. The Bobcats using all of the play clock. It's down to 15, 42 on the game clock. And now that clock continues to turn down to 10 on the play clock and 37 on the play clock, and this will be the last one. The Bobcats will take the knee, and that'll be it, and the guys will start shaking hands at the center part of the football field. The final score, the Bobcats knock off the Lions. Both teams came in at 3-0, but the Bobcats are the only ones that escape undefeated as they went in here 34-14 in this big rivalry between schools just a few miles apart here in Clarion County. We'll take a timeout. We'll come back. We'll get into the postgame show. And again, the final score, 34-14. The Bobcats a winner. You're listening to the KSAC Game of the Week, powered by the Triple R Roadhouse, and it's right here on exploreclarion.com.
Are you planning a party? Why not a pool party? Give them a party they will never forget at the Park Inn by Radisson. Right now, they are taking reservations for pool parties. You can book your party for any Sunday from 2 to 4 or from 5 to 7. Up to 25 people can attend. You can bring your own food, beverage, and cake. Who wouldn't want a poolside party? So throw a party with style at the Park Inn by Radisson. Just call 226-8850 to book your party today.
Looking for an apartment? Let Corsetti Rentals provide you with your housing needs. Come check out our townhouse rentals near Marianna States and on the east end of Clarion near Sheets and Clarion Ford. With student and non-student rentals located throughout the Clarion area, some within sight of Clarion University, and semester leases available too. Call Ron Corsetti Rentals at 226-8262. That's 226-8262 to schedule a showing.
Hey y'all, it's Lori from Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. RCBS reloading supplies are the best. We carry Charge Master combos, powder tricklers, hand priming tools, electronic and manual scales. Get the best RCBS reloading supplies at Route 66 Sporting Goods. Route 66 Sporting Goods, your RCBS headquarters. Located on Route 66, just north of Clarion, open 7 days a week. Call 814-226-4055 or visit us online at Route 66 Sporting Goods.
Hi, this is Amy with S&W Auto Body in Lucinda.
For over 25 years now, we have been providing auto body repair services for deer damage, collision, or your dings, dents, and scratches. We also install windshields, do general maintenance including oil changes, brakes, and state inspections. And for those of you who aren't car savvy, don't worry. Give us a call or stop in and we will talk you through your car issues to find the problem. S&W Auto Service Center, located on Shill Lane in Lucinda, where strangers are treated like friends and friends like family. 226-7046.
Black and blue brawl number one!
Guys,
tell them now. Run! Run!
We're here with Larry Weiser, Clarion Bobcats head football coach. He just won his 200th game tonight. It's been 28 years. What's it feel like, Larry?
It feels like the next game. You know what I mean? It's I'm still looking forward to next week. You know, once we get through tonight, enjoy a little bit of tonight. It's next week, and I'm not going to let sit there and lie. You know, I guess you know people have been telling me it's pretty neat, but. You know, right now, it's still we're in the middle of the battle for the season.
Mm-hmm. Talk about, you know, the point to get here and all the hard work and everything. Talk about some of that, some of the relationships you've been able to develop.
Well, I was kind of fortunate to be part of a pretty good staff when I started here at Clarion years ago. And Ray Austin, John Reich, and so forth like that. So I got my chance. I was just telling the officials on the sidelines that, you know, we got some fire before we had to enter in the burning house and so forth to be a head coach. And so we learned how to handle some of the stuff. And I learned a great deal from those guys. And then when I became head coach, man, I was surrounded by some good people, staff people and kids and community people over the years. You know, they all sound like cliches, but you don't survive this long without that kind of support, you know. And it's my theme with kids tonight has never been about me. It's about we and the community and the school and the players. I was